Coming to you live from Stuart, Florida, the greatest little town in the world. It's the Get Up and Go Show on AM 1450 WSTU. You're invited to call the show anytime at 772-220-9788. And now, broadcasting live from their palatial studios, here are your hosts, Evan and Bonnie.
6:07 on the Get Up and Go Show, and a happy Thursday to you.
You call this big market radio?
Well, yeah, we're about the biggest market that you can get.
Can we all please get back to work?
All right, we'll get back to work, I promise you.
Radio people are the coolest.
Yeah, I know we're the coolest, that's for darn sure. Kind of a little Christmassy jazz to get your morning going on the Get Up and Go Show.
I wish I could see a light snowfall outside during this.
Yeah, that would be kind of really cool.
You know, the snowflakes falling lightly. There's nothing like that first beautiful snowfall when you're up north.
I feel like I'm watching the Hallmark Channel right now.
I'm glad I'm not watching the Hallmark Channel right now.
I love the Hallmark Channel. I do. I like the Hallmark Channel.
That's
yeah,
cool.
It's pretty cool. Music kind of fits right with the Hallmark Channel.
Do you like Lifetime also?
Lifetime is good, yeah. I watch all that sappy crap.
Does it seem like you watch the same movie time and time and time again on Hallmark?
Over and over and over again.
Almost has the same synopsis every time, like Phil was mentioning. The girl loses her job, she loses her career, goes back to her old town.
Yeah.
Makes
finds
amends
the boyfriend.
With her parents, the old boyfriend from 30 years ago.
Yeah.
And they still have that spark of romance going.
And then they kiss under the damn mistletoe and they make up.
And they either stay in the country or move out with her to the big city.
Oh, yes, for sure. For sure.
And he becomes the head of a company.
Well, 1 week from tonight, it's the big night. The big man makes the rounds. That's right, Santa Claus.
Yeah.
Goes out on a sleigh and he'll be delivering Christmas presents.
Santa and Mrs. Claus, of course, were here last week. It was already a week ago Friday, wasn't
That's
it?
That's right. They were here.
And
in studio live.
Yep.
They were checking up on him.
Santa was looking good. It looked like he could use just a few pounds, so I hope Mrs. Claus fed him well all week.
I'm sure he gets fed very well.
And he'll be...
Never talk about Santa's weight, Bonnie. He'll leave you a lunk of coal.
We just want him to stay fluffy and warm while he's up in that cold sleigh riding around the world in the middle of the night.
Always fluffy, without a doubt.
Have a warm fire for Santa prepared, maybe.
For sure. So yesterday I went for treatment number 2 at the Slim Body Laser Spa, and I must say it was good. Got zapped with the laser. I won't say zap, but I mean, people are going to get scared. No, it's really a painless procedure. They put the lasers on my belly, and then I got on the vibration plate for 20 minutes, and I was out of there in an hour, drank my protein shake, and was taken very well care of. I got my, in fact, it's in my pocket here. Let me grab it here. Dr. Tread, they did an analysis of me yesterday. It's called a BMI? Yeah,
it
BMI.
Is,
yeah, body composition test.
Your body weight or body fat compared to your...
I was depressed.
Well,
here it is right here. Percentage of body fat, 35.8%. Fat body weight, 94.9 pounds. Lean body weight, 170.1 pounds.
Lean body weight.
Yeah, so if you add those two together, that's 265 pounds, which is my current weight, 265.
265.
Yeah.
That's not bad because you're very tall. You're like 6'1" or 6'2".
Well, it's not exactly the greatest.
Well, you know, you probably want to get an ideal weight for you would be about maybe 180.
Oh,
Evan?
No, that's too low. Too low.
210, maybe?
My total body water is 57.9 liters, 48.1% of body weight, and 75% of lean weight. The recommendations, the current body fat is 35.8%. My target is 20%.
Okay.
Yeah, target's 20%.
So you have, like, goals to reach. Do
these goals to reach
seem like attainable goals
for
you?
They're extremely very attainable. Current weight, 265. The target weight he would like to get me to is 212.
I believe you can make it there.
212.
Yeah. You've seen, like, the people on Taking Off the Weight programs.
Yeah.
Like, I think they had a reality series about it too, where, you know, well, they get out and they exercise like crazy, but then the physician kind of puts them on that really good diet, and some of them are able to take off the pounds quite fast.
My caloric intake right now is roughly, by this chart, about 2,300 and something. So he wants me to get, he wants me to go to about 2,000 for calories.
Didn't you say something in the 900 calorie mark yesterday?
Well, Nutrisystem is only like 900, 1,000 calories a day. I'm eating five times a day.
Oh, okay.
So, but that's 1,000 calories too less than what he wants. So I have to balance it out somewhere.
Well, don't stop on the way home and get yourself a Big Mac today.
No, don't tempt me. Trust me. Last night I... didn't eat dinner. I had just a small little snack for dinner. In fact, I brought one of my protein bars with me. So if I later on this morning when I get the urge, I'll slam down a protein bar.
Yeah, that's really good for you.
Yeah.
Do you mind me if I bring some lemon water for you one morning to drink?
No, that's fine. I've got a bottle of water in there. I Propel.
Yeah.
And I have my orange juice. That has my sugar.
Okay. Maybe when you come back, or maybe tomorrow morning, like maybe with a lemon and some juice in a jug, and I'll keep it ice cold for you.
Yeah, he said I can drink. He said that I can drink that kind of stuff too.
I heard him talk about some kind of diet to use, where he said to get up early in the morning and drink some lemon water,
right,
and then wait. And but then I'm trying to remember what he suggested to eat in the diet. Was it maybe one egg or something really low cal? And
well, he says to have an egg or something for breakfast. An egg is always good to have for breakfast. Protein shakes are good. So there's a whole litany of things. So I'm going to try to stick to it as much as I can and try to get down to, I think 212 is a little much. I want to get down to about 225, 230. I'll be comfortable there because that's where I was before.
You'll be feeling really good with that.
And did I ever show you my before and after picture when I did this once before?
I think you had. And yeah, you looked really lean in that after picture. Nice and tall and lean.
Here.
I think you were in a tux or a suit or something, weren't you?
Yeah, yeah.
I'm really proud of myself lately because it's the holiday season and I haven't even had any candy or cake or cookies in my house. No candy bars.
Oh.
I haven't bought any of the, Ferrero Rocher chocolates, the Lindt's, and instead I've been enjoying nature's candy.
Oh.
I have grapes.
Grapes are good.
Loads of grapes in my refrigerator and I get those nice big kind of red California grapes. They're oh so sweet and they're seedless.
Okay, so there you go. There's left is before, right is after.
Oh, yeah. There's quite a change, a difference.
Huge difference.
I mean, you look good in both photos.
Oh, no.
I
look
like
awful. Look at how big my face is there.
It is.
Look at that, and then look at that picture.
You don't strike me as being like a really obese person.
Yeah, well.
But I can tell the one
I don't
on the
like that person.
You don't,
I really don't. I'm not happy with that person. That person I like.
Uh-huh.
So.
Very lean.
That person's coming back.
Yeah, that's a good thing. How many weeks now are you going to be going to Dr. Tread?
It's 9 sessions.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, 9 sessions.
Uh-huh. And when you get in that, does it feel that wiggling on your tummy? Does it feel like you're getting in a nice hot whirlpool or something with the jets?
No, what it does, it's circulating your blood, your blood flow and things like that. That's the purpose of the vibration plate. He would have to explain it to you and go into more detail. That's where my short-term memory doesn't, sit well with me because I don't remember things like that. But when he did tell me, it did sink in.
Yeah.
So as far as that goes.
Well, you're going to be giving a testimonial with him, I would believe. Wait, not this coming Tuesday?
Well, no, when I'm done. When I'm fully done, we're gonna measure me and how much I lost and how many inches I lost. And we're going to talk about my experience. And I think I may become a spokesperson for Slim Body Laser as well. So we'll see.
You're putting on a brave face, too, because it's at a different time where, you know, people don't have the energy or the stamina to do this right before Christmas with all of that Christmas food we're going to be enjoying.
Yeah, yeah, and in a lot of stories he tells me, a lot of people are embarrassed to, admit what's wrong and things like that. And I'm not embarrassed. I have an addiction problem. It's not a drug addiction problem. It's a food addiction problem is what it is. And I'm going to fix that. I'm going to detoxify. And, you know, I had my, I took my vitamins this morning. I'm taking zinc, vitamin C, vitamin D. I'm taking elderberry now.
Okay.
All these things that I'm taking now are actually, believe it or not, what the doctor says to take if you get COVID. You know, you're supposed to take zinc. You're supposed to take vitamin D, all that stuff, vitamin C. So I'm, you know, I'm taking all these things now just to be on the cautious side.
Do you have any nasal allergies where you take what I do? I take a lot of Benadryl with antihistamine.
That I don't have to. Thank the Lord I don't have that.
Yeah.
So I don't have to worry about that. I use the nose strips when I go to bed at night.
Uh-huh.
And that lifts and opens up my my septum inside, and it allows me to breathe a little bit better.
Because I tend to eat a lot too, and I think the reason being is I do take a lot of the Benadryl, and I was reading that the antihistamine in your Benadryl that you're taking, not only does it block off that itch and that sinus problem in your nose, but it also, I read that it also blocks something off in your brain that tells your brain that
you shouldn't eat?
That you should eat more.
Oh.
It's like a numbing in the brain when you're taking so much Benadryl.
Very interesting.
That you tend to eat more with it. Because I noticed for a week or two when I went off of it, my appetite decreased.
Well,
when
I can tell you this much. I won't be taking any Benadryl anytime soon. That's for sure.
No.
Because I don't want to, I don't need to eat more food.
Yeah.
So that's as far as that goes.
People can get addicted to that stuff, too. I'm telling you, even last night, I'm thinking right before I go to bed, oh, boy, I would like to have two of these pink and white pills, my Benadryl pills.
Gotcha.
I started to pour myself a glass of water, and I thought, you know what? Your allergies aren't that bad tonight, Bonnie.
There you go.
Do you really need... And I know they help me sleep, too,
you
because try it puts me to sleep.
You should try those nose strips that I use. They honestly will help you breathe better at night, because all they do, it's not a drug or a medicine that goes in your pores or anything like that. All it is, it's just it's like a Band-Aid that has a little thin piece of metal in it.
Uh-huh.
And what it does, it lifts your nostrils up, so it increases airflow going in.
Beautiful.
So you can actually breathe. And they work very, very well. You see a lot of football players wear those when they're playing football.
Ah, yeah.
So they can breathe better.
And do they have a little bit of menthol, too, in the
strip? No, like I said, there's no drug. There's nothing on it. It's just a Band-Aid. That's all it is.
Mm-hmm.
It's a Band-Aid with a little metal spring in it that you wipe your nose off first, wipe all the grease off your nose, and then you center it in the center of your nose, and then you just push it down, and then it lifts up right here, and it helps you breathe. And
sleep,
I'm telling
at
you,
ease.
Yeah, I sleep a lot better with it. I tend to. I can breathe a little bit better.
Mm-hmm.
So as far as that goes, you have a big day today later on, don't you?
Yeah.
You got like a whole lot of people you're going to be rubbing the right way.
Yeah. I know a lot of my everybody I know is coming tonight, people that tend to go to me for massage. And it's going to be like a really busy Thursday night.
You're going to be on a massage marathon.
I guess so.
Poor Gary's not going to know what to do. You're going to walk in the door. You're going to be all verklempt when you walk in. You're going to pass out, and he's going to have to cook you dinner and spoon feed you and everything.
Yeah, well, Gary works right alongside me tonight. He's working with me tonight, too.
Oh, so you're both going to be verklempt tonight.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, jeez. Wow.
And I'm doing a little bit of a stretch tonight. The gentleman that gave me the 2020 Donald Trump 2020 bill he's coming in.
Okay, very good.
Yeah.
Very good.
He was always leaving those nice tips of Donald Trump on my table.
All right, very good. So you guys will be, by the time you get home, you'll be verklempt. There won't be any chutzpah or nothing like that going on in your house tonight. And you guys will pretty much be passed out, and you'll be back here bright and early for my final show of the week. And then I'll be on vacation next week.
Yeah.
You're going to be going up with G and Ray. It's going to be a blended show for 4 days. Because on the fifth day of next week, it's Christmas Day.
Can you believe it?
They're going to be playing holiday music on our station all
day. I love it.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm going to turn our station on with my Alexa while I'm cooking.
There you go. Alexa, turn on WSTU AM 1450. And just like that, all the radios right now across the Treasure Coast are playing our radio station. 621, it's news time. Let's head on over to the news desk where Bonnie has the morning headlines. Good morning, Bonnie.
Good morning, Evan. Indian River State College has received the largest donation in its history, $45 million, putting it among nearly 400 organizations getting donations from philanthropist Mackenzie Scott. The donation was announced Wednesday. In the past 4 months, Scott has given nearly $4.2 billion to 384 organizations across all 50 states, she said Tuesday in a Medium post. The donation to IRSC will support initiatives at the college, such as growing career training and degree programs, according to the college. Some school districts in our area are now reaching out to Tallahassee and asking Florida Governor Ron DeSantis to make teachers a priority for the COVID-19 vaccine. WPTV's Ryan Hughes has details.
For 18 years, Chris Waldrop has been teaching students, but he says balancing in-person instruction and virtual learning has been his biggest challenge during the pandemic at St. Lucie West Centennial High School.
There'll be times where, like, my physical class will have 26 students in it, and then all of a sudden there's a quarantine list sent out, and like 10 of those kids are gone.
St. Lucie School Superintendent Wayne Jen says he expects more students to return to the classroom after winter break and is now having conversations about the COVID-19 vaccine and getting educators vaccinated.
So that is a priority for us to make sure that when the next batch comes out, that those that have direct contact with students are included.
Jen says he will take the vaccine, but it would be voluntary for teachers and staff.
This will be just one less thing that needs to be worried about by our instructors, our teachers, our bus drivers.
Here in Martin County, the school board voted Tuesday night to send a formal request to Governor Ron DeSantis asking district employees with direct contact with students to be considered a priority to receive the vaccine.
The governor has said he expects the Johnson & Johnson vaccine to receive approval after the new year. And on Tuesday in West Palm Beach, the governor said it's expected to only require one dose.
That makes it easier to do on a mass scale because you can go and in a school district can offer to the teachers one shot and you don't have to worry about going back.
Waldrop does not want to be pushed to the front of the line, but says he does want the vaccine.
I hope people would understand the importance of getting the vaccine so that we can all be healthy and, you know, live somewhat of a normal life again.
Ryan Hughes, WPTV, News Channel 5.
Months away from a COVID-19 vaccine for the general public, and there is new guidance for pregnant women and nursing mothers. WPTV's Michelle Quesada has the story.
As 2020 comes to a close and we get closer to a COVID-19 vaccine becoming available, many expecting mothers and women who are nursing will have a decision to make. Whatever the decision, the American College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists says the vaccine should not be withheld from them.
All smiles this holiday season, the Arriero Fajeras in Jupiter are nearing the end of a pregnancy in a pandemic.
We've been really hardcore about just isolation and staying away from people.
Elizabeth is due in January, and even though the COVID-19 vaccine won't be available for now, she, like many other women building a family, has a lot to consider.
Because we do plan to have one more kid ultimately, I do want to wait a little while to get one myself.
This week, the American College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists published an article saying pregnant women and lactating mothers should not be excluded from getting a COVID-19 vaccine.
To me, it doesn't mean that we need to run out there and enroll all our pregnant patients to get the vaccine.
Board certified OBGYN Dr. Colette Brown Graham says pregnant and nursing women should discuss the vaccine with their doctors and know the risks of not getting it.
If you are pregnant and you get COVID, there is a higher chance that you will get mechanical ventilation. There's a higher chance that you will go into an ICU.
Dr. Brown Graham points out the makeup of the vaccine is messenger RNA, which does not change DNA. Still, with no pregnant women included in the trials, she says she will be on the lookout for new data, but adds there is another alternative.
If everyone around the pregnant patient or pregnant person has gotten the vaccine, we're essentially creating a herd immunity for that pregnant patient.
Elizabeth agrees creating a cocoon of vaccinated relatives around her and the baby may be the safest option.
We're just excited for the little one to get here and you know, continue what we've been doing to stay healthy and safe.
Michelle Quesada, WPTV News Channel 5.
Lastly, in Port St. Lucie, Cleveland Clinic of Florida purchased 44 acres near its Tradition Hospital from the city for $5.7 million, but what might be built there remains unknown. NFL owners have delayed a decision on implementing a 17-game regular season for 2021 during a teleconference call Wednesday that replaced the usual December gathering of owners in Dallas. They opted to push back any move on the expanded season until early in 2021. The NFL and the players' union agreed during collective bargaining talks earlier this year to add one regular season game to the schedule, but not before next season. News time is 6:27. We'll have weather and traffic together next.
This will be another El Nino year, although a weaker one. So if you incurred roof damage in the last 2 years, Code Red Roofers is there to help you with all of your roofing needs. Code Red Roofers, the roofers who respond 24/7. And there are flexible payment options for metal, tile, shingle, or flat roofs. Code Red Roofers, se habla español. Code Red Roofers, 844-4-CODE-RED. That's 844-4-CODE-RED.
.628, the time on the Get Up and Go show with Evan and Bonnie. I had to think for a minute. The name's there. Sorry. Anyway, it's time for traffic and weather together. It's all brought to you by Code Red Roofers. Bonnie?
Well, nothing to report on our highways for this Thursday morning, so roads are looking good. If you're just heading out, there's your latest look at traffic. 72 with clouds in Stuart, and in Portsmouth, New Hampshire, it's only 15 above with a cloudy sky. Here's our weather at WPTV.
It is going to be a relatively warm morning along the Treasure Coast. We've got some clouds overhead. Also, chance for some patchy fog, too. We will see a stray sprinkle possible early, but a better chance of some isolated downpours into the late morning and early afternoon hours. Temperatures still going to climb into the low and middle 70s for your afternoon high temperatures. As we look toward tonight, that cold front moves on through. Jacket weather does return. I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Harrison Hove on WSTU AM 1450, Martin County's Heritage Station.
Unfortunately, in today's litigious society, too many Americans fail to have an effective estate plan and asset protection strategy. I'm attorney TJ Heineman, and I've been counseling families, businesses, and executives for 20 years. I can help you preserve your wealth, safeguard your assets, and protect your family. My law firm specializes in estate planning and administration, asset protection, corporate law, and real estate. For a free copy of my Family Estate Planning Survival Guide or a free consultation in my Palm City office, call me, TJ Heineman, at 888-5667.
The professionals at Mark Breckville Certified Public Accountants are proud to sponsor Treasure Coast Solutions, a community service program designed to provide information you can use, a local perspective on national issues, local solutions to meet your individual concerns. At our firm, we believe that information is knowledge, and with knowledge comes the power to have a positive impact on our lives, businesses, schools, and community. If you would like one of our professionals to address your personal financial or business concerns, please give us a call to set up an appointment at 220-3380.
Experience Heathco Botanical Gardens in Fort Pierce in a whole new light at the 6th Annual Garden of Lights. Be dazzled by thousands of lights crafted in whimsical garden designs. This is an outdoor event and masks are required. There will be refreshments and a holiday photo op with Heathcoat the Bear. The evening event kicks off Thanksgiving weekend and runs through New Year's. For tickets and more information, visit heathcoatbotanicalgardens.org.
If you have a suggestion for the show, we would love to hear from you. Send us an email to wstumorningshow@gmail.com. Now let's get back to the Get Up and Go show. Here's Evan and Bonnie.
And now for your entertainment pleasure, Christmas dad jokes from Santa's little helper.
Thank you, thank you. What do Santa's elves learn at school? The alphabet. What do you get if you eat Christmas decorations? Tinselitis. What does Santa Claus suffer from when he gets stuck in the chimney? Claustrophobia. And what do they sing at a snowman's birthday party? Freeze a jolly good fellow. Thank you.
On the 12th day of COVID, my country gave to me
12 nurses masking,
11 doctors freaking,
10 restaurants closing,
9 patients wheezing,
8 ventilators,
7 hands a-washing,
6 feet a-parting,
5 new vaccines,
4 latex gloves,
3 kids homeschooled,
2 nasal swabs,
and it's all clear for COVID-19.
Yeah! There you go, 12 days of COVID.
No, thanks.
12 days of COVID.
I don't even want one day of COVID.
I don't want no days of COVID,
no.
Period.
And I'm just hearing from different crowds how different people, how it's, you know, affected, the COVID is affecting them.
Yeah.
I heard a little news story yesterday, too, that sometimes the after effects can run for weeks with some people. But, of course, like you mentioned, too, that it varies from
it
person
really depends.
To person.
Everybody, it depends on a lot of things.
I remember, though, having the flu in the past, Evan.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll tell you what, even after you have the flu, you still feel like for 3 or 4 days following that you got run over by a Mack truck.
Wow,
I swear.
Want to say good morning to the, we have two people watching us on Facebook Live right now. Don't know who they are because they haven't checked in and said good morning. So if you'd like to put your name in the comments and say good morning to us, we'll give you a shout out on the radio. In the meantime, a study looked at the most in-demand Christmas gifts in all 50 states. The PlayStation 5 is number one in only 6 states, believe it or not, and the iPhone 12 is next in 5. The PlayStation 5, it's the most sought-after gift in Delaware, Georgia, Louisiana, Maryland, Pennsylvania, and Rhode Island. The new Xbox 5 got 3 states only, at North Carolina, Oklahoma, and Nevada, Bonnie.
Well, I'm surprised. You know, that must mean people are, like, downloading these to make their purchases with these kind of items, probably how they're finding this.
Right.
It just surprises me that PlayStation 5 wouldn't be the most popular in more states, especially maybe the colder ones.
Yeah,
like
exactly.
Up in North Dakota and the Dakotas and maybe Wisconsin, Minnesota. Up there, I know you mentioned Rhode Island,
right.
One of them. But.
Right. Apple products are also very big right now. The iPhone 12 is number one in only 5 states, California, Hawaii, Illinois, Missouri, and Jersey. The iPad Air 4 is first in Alabama and Massachusetts, and the Apple Watch watches top the list in Texas and only Virginia. So it's really amazing about that.
With the Apple Watch now, it seems to me that Topanga got that in her Christmas items last year.
Mm-hmm.
I know she got this cool kind of watch that Santa brought her.
Right.
But, yeah, and where was it popular in? What states?
It was popular in Texas and Virginia. Texas and Virginia.
Oh, just two of them.
Yeah, Samsung Galaxy products got 5 states that they're popular in: Montana, New Hampshire, West Virginia, Kansas, and New Mexico. 2 video games made the list, Assassin's Creed in Idaho and North Dakota, and Cyberpunk 2077 in Alaska, Oregon, and Washington.
Mm-hmm.
Fitbits are number 1 right now in Iowa, South Dakota, and Wisconsin. Vector Robots in Colorado, Indiana, and Minnesota. Keurigs, Bonnie, listen to this. In Arizona and Michigan is where they are the most popular.
That's interesting. And not in Florida?
No, where, not at all.
And I've purchased a few.
Yeah. And 4 products only got 1 each state. Harry Potter wands in Kentucky, patio heaters in Connecticut, Simple Dimple fidget toys in Florida, and everyone in Ohio wants an air hockey table in their basement.
Interesting.
Yeah, pretty interesting stuff going on there.
And you mentioned those heaters for the patios. I think they're needing them up in Connecticut right now. They probably want the heaters to melt all of the snow with a heavy snowfall coming in.
Another interesting reading that I found I wanted to share with our listeners. Google just released its annual year in search stats. and election results beat coronavirus for the most Googled phrase of 2020. Here's a rundown of the top searches, news stories, and how-to questions, and much more. The top 10 searches this year on Google were election results, coronavirus, Kobe Bryant, coronavirus updates, coronavirus symptoms, Zoom, who is winning the election, Naya Rivera, who passed away in July, Chadwick Boseman, who passed away in August, and PlayStation 5.
PlayStation 5,
yep.
Yes.
Yeah, that's the top 10 searches on Google this year.
And I'm one of those many that downloaded to search for coronavirus symptoms, of course.
The top hard news topics that were Googled this year, election results, coronavirus, stimulus checks, unemployment, and Iran. Those are the top hard news topics. The top recipes that people searched for this year, sourdough bread, whipped coffee, Disney churro, Dole Whip, and Double Tree Cookie. Yeah.
What's Dole Whip?
Dole Whip. D-O-L-E. Dole Whip.
Oh, Dole Whip.
Dole Whip, yes. Dole Whip.
Is that like a whipped cream with Dole pineapples
or
something?
I don't know what Dole Whip is.
I'm not sure either.
Google it. That's all I can tell you.
Yeah.
There you go. Like what we're talking about. The top how-to-make searches this year on Google. How to make hand sanitizer. How to make a face mask. How to make whipped coffee. How to make a mask with a bandana. And how to make a mask without sewing. Those were the top how-to-make searches on Google. The top near-me searches, Bonnie. COVID testing near me. Early voting near me. Fires near me. Voting near me.
Oh, yeah.
Protests near me. And the number one search this year for near me on Google, toilet paper near me. Yes.
Yep. And during the month of, was it March and April, there sure wasn't a whole lot of it near me.
Yeah, now you can find it everywhere.
I know. Thank goodness.
The top virtual searches were for virtual field trips, virtual museum tours, virtual Kentucky Derby.
I want to take a virtual museum tour.
Virtual
Wouldn't
learning.
Wouldn't that be fun?
Yeah. Virtual learning and virtual NBA fans. The top where is questions were, where is my stimulus check? Where is my refund? Where is Kansas City? Because back in February, President Trump congratulated Kansas on the Kansas City Chiefs Super Bowl win.
Okay, so...
So that's why everybody was Googling, where is Kansas City?
And some people might get confused. Is it Kansas City, Missouri, or Kansas City, Kansas?
Right, exactly. Right? The top how-to-donate searches were for Black Lives Matter, the fires in Australia, and how to donate blood.
Oh, those fires in Australia were horrible.
And the number one where-to-buy search this year was where to buy PS5. It beat where to buy toilet paper and where to buy face masks. And finally, the top why question this year was, quote, why were chainsaws invented?
Why were chainsaws
that
invented?
That was the top why question of the year.
Really?
Yep. The topic went viral on TikTok last month after somebody heard they were used for childbirth, which is actually true. The first chainsaw was a small hand crank thing invented in the 1700s to cut cartilage during difficult births.
Was it really?
Yes.
I have never heard that.
Yeah.
Because my dad, my
very,
father.
Very, very true.
My father was a logger. You know, he's a tree man, and he always used a chainsaw.
Mm-hmm.
And when you're saying this, Evan, I'm thinking, yeah, the chainsaw has something to do with trees.
Yeah.
And they needed the wood fire burning, and
exactly.
They needed a better way to chop the wood.
Very, very, very true fact.
But a little tiny gadget called a chainsaw for pregnancy and giving birth?
Yeah. That was way back in the 1700s.
That's astounding.
They used it for cutting the cartilage on difficult births.
Yeah.
Yes, and this is true.
This,
true stuff.
This
could you imagine
is like the
today?
First time I've heard
can you imagine
this?
Today going into the delivery room and you're waiting and you're you're a dad and the OBGYN is in there and you're ready to give birth naturally and they're telling you to push and then all of a sudden the doctor you know comes out of a separate room and all of a sudden you hear ring.
Yeah, he brings out a little chainsaw.
Brings out a little chainsaw and you're like, "What the heck is going on?"
It's like, "No thanks." Of course, you know, I've never been in labor before and I only hear about how painful it really can be.
Do you think you could handle labor, Bonnie?
Could I?
Do you think you could handle labor?
Oh, I would be in tears.
Would you?
You know, I would have to handle it, I guess, until
I mean, they
the
have
baby
all
arrived.
These, they have all these newfangled drugs. They have epidurals where it makes you numb. Just all sorts of things.
I would probably have to do the epidural thing. Yeah. Oh, you mentioned people were looking up Dole Whip before.
Yeah.
That was one of the most searched
Did you find it?
Foods. Yeah, Dole Whip is a pineapple-flavored soft-serve ice cream.
Oh.
It was originally created by the fruit company Dole, but became available at Disneyland's Tiki Bar in 1986.
Nice. Very, very, very nice. 6:42 once again. Let's go to the news desk where Bonnie's standing by with the headlines. Good morning, Bonnie.
Good morning, Evan. President-elect Joe Biden and Vice President Mike Pence are set to receive the COVID-19 vaccine soon. According to two transition officials familiar with the matter, Biden will receive the vaccine publicly as early as next week. The officials spoke on condition of anonymity because they weren't authorized to discuss it publicly. The White House says Pence and his wife Karen will receive the vaccine publicly on Friday. According to USA Today, Surgeon General Jerome Adams will also be vaccinated on Friday. Seniors in more than 100 long-term care facilities in Broward and Pinellas counties, plus a handful in Miami-Dade, are beginning to receive the COVID-19 vaccine, but that program will soon be expanding.
You're going to see CVS and Walgreens start getting in these facilities on Monday.
Governor Ron DeSantis says the chains will have 60,000 doses, which should last them between a week and 10 days. And the wait is over for seniors across the state anticipating their coronavirus vaccine and a little piece of freedom.
Over the next week, state and other experts will visit more than 100 long-term care facilities in Broward, Miami-Dade, and Pinellas counties armed with vials of the valuable vaccine. CVS and Walgreens staffers could begin administering their 60,000 doses Monday. Florida Emergency Management Director Jared Moskowitz says these facilities have been struck with more than COVID.
It was isolation. It was being disconnected from their family members. It was not being able to have visitors. And so this is the beginning of the end to all of that.
Once the Moderna vaccine is approved, more than 350,000 doses of it will be shipped to Florida hospitals. Erica Rodriguez, Miami.
The coronavirus vaccine is already being administered to Florida's frontline healthcare workers.
I got mine at the beginning of my shift, and I felt fine. A little bit sore in my arm now, but other than that, I felt good. I got through my shift.
Yes.
In Orlando, Advent Health nurse manager Sue Upper says a line of doctors stretched into the lobby as they queued up to get the vaccine. Advent Health received its first shipment of 20,000 vaccine doses earlier this week. Disney Cruise Line is canceling all cruises until March. The company made that announcement yesterday, citing coronavirus concerns. Guests booked on affected sailings who have paid their reservations in full will be offered the choice of a cruise credit or a full refund. Dozens of buildings are damaged after a tornado ripped through Pinellas County. It also hit Hillsborough and Polk counties, beginning just before 4 yesterday. The National Weather Service says the twister covered over 50 miles in 2 hours. So far, no injuries have been reported. Lastly, SpaceX is set to launch a spy satellite into orbit for the U.S. National Reconnaissance Office this morning. The flight is scheduled to blast off from Pad 39A at Kennedy Space Center during a planned 3-hour window that opens at 9 a.m. However, the exact liftoff time has not yet been announced. Drew Brees has been designated to return to practice. But New Orleans Saints coach Sean Payton said the quarterback still has a ways to go in his recovery from 11 broken ribs and a punctured lung We haven't ruled anything just because we don't have to. Pating told reporters after Wednesday's practice when asked if there's a chance that Breeze could play on Sunday. He's got a ways to go still, and he's someone we're not just going to hurry back and just put him in the game. News time is 6:46. Weather and traffic together coming up.
Stepped into St. Lucie Jewelry and Coins, I figured it would just be one of my many stops on my road to the perfect engagement ring. My fiancé means the world to me, so I wanted something extra special. I found a huge selection of engagement rings at great prices, and my worry about finding the perfect engagement ring was quickly replaced with exceptional customer service. St. Lucie Jewelry's over 400 five-star reviews really told the story. I finally picked a ring, and it was perfect. She was floored. And then the tears came.
Hi, this is Hawk Levy, owner of St. Lucie Jewelry and Coins. We're now celebrating 26 years, voted best diamond dealers, best jewelry buyers, and best jeweler year after year. Come celebrate with us in opening our third location at 1335 St. Lucie West Boulevard next to Publix. We invite you to take a tour of our competition, but then come see us last.
.647 right now on the Get Up and Go Show with Evan and Bonnie. It's time for traffic and weather together, all brought to you by Code Red Roofers. Bonnie?
Well, there is an accident to the south of us. I-95 southbound at Palm Beach Gardens at Donald Ross Road. There is a vehicle crash with injuries and roadblock down there. So, you know, if you're heading down that way, you're going to see some delay as two right lanes are blocked and there's some debris in the center lane. And there's your latest look at traffic. Right now, it's 70 in Port St. Lucie. In Christchurch, New Zealand, 56. Here's our forecast at WPTV.
It is going to be relatively warm morning along the Treasure Coast. We've got some clouds overhead. Also, chance for some patchy fog, too. We will see a stray sprinkle possible early, but a better chance of some isolated downpours into the late morning and early afternoon hours. Temperatures still going to climb into the low and middle 70s for your afternoon high temperatures. As we look toward tonight, that cold front moves on through. Jacket weather does return. I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Harrison Hove on WSTU AM 1450, Martin County's Heritage Station.
It's all about income, not spending down your principal. And anyone who tells you otherwise simply does not understand proper retirement planning. Hi, I'm Michael Burley of P Capital Management, inviting you to tune in to the Retirement Income Program. Powerful truths that you must know and understand so you may live the retirement you deserve. The key to retirement success is income. Tune in to the Retirement Income Program every Monday evening at 6 on WSTU.
So, have you heard this one? A priest and a rabbi come into this radio station. Really, it's a priest and a rabbi right here Friday mornings beginning at 9 here on WSTU AM 1450. Bring your questions and join their lively conversation with Father Christian from St. Mary's Episcopal Church and Rabbi Matt Durbin from the Temple Beit Hayim. It's a priest and a rabbi Friday mornings at 9 here on WSTU.
What is your quality of life? The Owen Insurance Group plans on improving it on our Quality of Life radio show Tuesday mornings at 10 on both WPSL and WSTU. Hi, I'm Gary Owen of the Owen Insurance Group. Along with Tom Bouvier, we'll help you on the road of life and make it a better one. Don't forget the Quality of Life radio show Tuesdays at 10 on WPSL and WSTU on TuneIn and Alexa.
Some of the best plants to attract birds to your yard. That's coming up on This Land of Ours.
Are you stuck inside but looking for bargains on new and secondhand goods? Try HiBid.com, the online auction site for just about anything. HiBid.com offers a safe and easy way to find hundreds of thousands of items for sale every day. From rare coins to fine jewelry, tools to vintage toys, and classic cars to real estate, HiBid.com has it all. HiBid.com makes it easy to find what you're looking for, and the site is simple to use. Come to HiBid.com. HIBID.com. That's HIBID.com. And start discovering great deals today.
For generations, we've worked the land. We've faced hardships and uncertainty before. But you can depend on Florida's farmers. We will continue to rise before dawn and harvest our crops, ensuring that Florida-grown fruits and vegetables are in your stores and that your family is fed. We are providers for our families and yours. We're Florida's farmers. We're in this together.
By planting fruit-bearing trees and shrubs in your landscape, they will attract berry-eating birds such as bluebirds and robins, while also creating a beautiful display with their flowers, fall and holiday colors, and fruits. American Cranberry Bush Viburnum has white springtime flowers, maple-shaped leaves that turn bright colors in autumn, and red fall berries. Brown thrashers, cedar waxwings, and other birds feast on the long-lasting fruits, which can provide a source of food even in the winter. The red twig dogweed is also a standout in winter because of its bold red stems, and also features clusters of small white flowers in spring, white fruits in summer and fall, and bold red-orange autumn color. Brown thrashers are fond of chokeberries, and so are cedar waxwings and other songbirds. A North American native counterpart to burning bush is the wahoo, which produces bright scarlet berries in autumn and has red fall colors that make for an attractive, informal hedge. I'm Kathy Isom, Southeast AgNet.
If you have a suggestion for the show, we would love to hear from you. Send us an email to WSTUmorningshow@gmail.com. Now let's get back to the Get Up and Go show. Here's Evan and Bonnie.
He was a meth head with an unhealthy attraction to farm animals.
Sir, step away from the cow.
She was the county sheriff with a heart of gold. Tonight on Hallmark's Countdown to Christmas, the Hallmark Channel original, A County Jail Christmas.
Pookie, I got you something for Christmas.
Lime chili shrimp ramen. I love you, Sheriff.
Regardless of how you smuggle it in, love is never contraband.
Sheriff, can you make a sound like a goat?
A County Jail Christmas.
Oh, Sheriff.
Only on the Hallmark Channel.
Have a 2020 Christmas if you made it through the year. Stay at home, no place to go till the virus disappears. Have a 2020 Christmas when you're walking down the street. Wear a mask is all we ask and keep away 6 feet. Oh no, the COVID grows, it's too much for me. Binge watching Netflix now, waiting for vaccine. Have a 2020 Christmas, and in case you didn't hear, 2020 is the Grinch we all wish will soon disappear.
That song pretty much sums it right up, Bonnie.
It really does.
A 2020 Christmas. I mean, that just sums everything right up for 2020.
And you know, Evan, I heard that some people are breathing like a sigh of relief this year, secretly just breathing a sigh of relief that they don't have to host their holiday Christmas parties.
Oh, I know.
Are you breathing that sigh of relief too, Evan?
You know, this past Sunday was supposed to have been my 11th annual holiday party that the wife and I puts on, where we open our doors for everybody and, invite our friends and family and friends of friends, and Santa comes to the house and has a very special intimate visit.
Kids
with
in the
children in the neighborhood. I mean, we have people we don't even know that come in, and we feed everybody, and it's just something we've been doing for 11 years. 10 years, actually. We decorate our home literally to the hilt. We have must have 7 or 9 Christmas trees in the house. We have at least 25 blow-ups in the yard. Lights go into music. But this year, nothing. Zero, zip, zilch.
Do you feel good with that kind of break?
I do. It's nice to have that break, but at the same time, I miss it. I really do. But I have nobody to do it for.
Yeah.
That's why I didn't do it.
You know, I just watched Christmas with the Cranks recently with Tim Allen. and Jamie Lee Curtis, uh-huh. and they wanted to skip Christmas,
wow.
and they just wanted to go on a cruise
Crazy.
And make that so. But just think, even if you kind of skip your Christmas celebrations, you can't even go on that cruise this
yeah,
holiday
exactly.
season, really.
Hey, good morning. Merry Christmas to you. You're on the air with Evan and Bonnie, and who do we have the pleasure of speaking with?
Ho, 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 and I don't get to cook the turkey this year.
Oh, that's right. I forgot about that. The other thing, George is not coming down this year. Jordan, in fact, George would have been here this week to celebrate with us. He usually comes down. He's been coming down for years at Christmas, and we get a turkey, and it's
wow.
actually the turkey is sitting in the deep freeze as we speak because I need George to come down and cook the damn thing.
And Bonnie, the Dole Whip.
Yeah.
You get them at Disney World. At Gastro's, where Gastro's at. Evan, I know you were at Gastro's at.
Yeah.
We're over. Dole Whip is really good.
Wow.
It looks good.
Yeah.
Does your mom like it too, George? Does she get it when she
oh,
goes?
Yeah. Well, she's only been to Disney World one time.
Oh, yeah.
I took her, what was it, last year, I think it was.
Yeah.
So,
it looks really good with that pineapple flavor in the Dole Whip. It looks just a cool pineapple sherbet or something.
Yeah. What they do is they take the pineapple and they get some heavy whipping cream,
mm-hmm.
And they put it through the ice cream maker and all that. Oh yeah!
Wow.
That sounds really, really
good.
Hey,
let's get a weather report from Kentucky this morning. What's going on up there?
Oh my gosh! Well, we had rain last night,
okay.
which means, and it's in the 20s. So guess what that means?
You got some snow.
No ice.
Oh, okay. ice, baby.
Yeah, with the roads are ice and all that. So, God, that means the people up here go out there and we'll hear a lot of crashes.
Wow.
People don't know how to drive through it up there yet, George.
Oh, are you kidding me? My gosh.
Maybe they get fooled by what's called black ice.
Yeah, black ice is very dangerous.
It is.
Yeah.
It's very, very dangerous.
So
you're just going to kind of hang out in Kentucky this year. It's weird not having you here. I'm telling you.
Yeah.
Very strange.
It's a strange one.
Well, you can still hop in your truck and make it down here by next week. I mean, I'm on vacation all week next week. We have a lot of time to spend together. Notice he avoided that.
Yeah, I do.
I got doctor's appointments and all that kind of stuff. So.
All right.
Are you going to put on your apron up there and do some holiday cooking?
Hey, maybe he can virtually walk me through cooking the turkey.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't do holiday cooking. I do Christmas cooking. Okay?
Okay.
All right. Well, send some Christmas cookies down.
All right, send some Christmas cookies down.
Yeah, I'm going to start making Christmas cookies here in a little, this week.
All right, sounds good. We got to run. We're coming up to the news, G, and I will talk to you a little later.
All right, later.
Have a good one, George.
Have a nice day, George.
We're WSTU Stuart, Martin County's Heritage Station. The news is coming up next. Enjoy some nice Christmas jazz.
Thinks a lot of Americans should stay there. Don't go to anyone else's.
Christmas is next week, and now Dr. Anthony Fauci, the nation's top infectious disease expert, is urging Americans not to travel to see their family. In an interview with the Washington Post, Fauci said he and his wife are not going to see their three adult children next week. Fauci noted that many Americans ignored travel warnings over Thanksgiving, and Christmas cannot be travel as usual.
Fox's Matt Finn, the COVID surge is worse than ever. Almost a 250,000 new cases yesterday in the U.S., more than 3,600 deaths, also a record, and the number of coronavirus patients in hospitals again at an all-time high. Today, a second vaccine gets FDA consideration made by Moderna.
If everything stays on track, I hope within days we'll see the FDA authorization of the Moderna vaccine.
Health and Human Services Secretary Alex Azar, nearly 6 million doses are ready to go out.
Congress may finally work out a deal for more Corona financial aid. Fox's Rachel Sutherland has an update live.
Dave, more direct payments could go out to some Americans under an emerging coronavirus relief plan, but they won't be as large as the first round, around $600 or $700. Republicans are backing away from liability protections for businesses, and Democrats are giving up on aid for state and local governments for now. The roughly $900 billion proposal could pass by the end of the week, as lawmakers race to approve a larger omnibus spending bill to avoid a government shutdown. Dave?
Rachel, a winter storm from North Carolina to Maine is making life difficult for shippers to move packages and for people making money, making deliveries like this DoorDash driver.
Christmas.
This COVID has had everyone in shambles. I'm just here trying to do something productive and make some money to get through the holidays.
Two people were killed in a highway pileup in Pennsylvania. America's listening to Fox News.
At Fisher Investments, we do things differently, and other money managers don't understand why.
Because our way works great for us.
But it may not work for your clients. That's why Fisher Investments is a fiduciary, obligated to put clients first. It's the highest standard for a financial advisor.
So, what do you provide? Cookie-cutter portfolios like the rest of us?
No cookie-cutter portfolios here. Fisher Investments tailors portfolios to meet each client's goals and needs.
But you do sell investments that earn you high commissions, right? And make commissions when you make trades for your clients?
No, Fisher Investments doesn't sell any commission investment products, and we never earn commissions on trades.
So what's in it for you?
Fisher Investments fees are structured so we do better when our clients do better. When it comes to helping clients achieve a comfortable retirement, we're clearly different. Visit FisherInvestments.com to find out why investors like you switch to us. Fisher Investments, clearly different money management.
Investments in securities involve the risk of loss.
While President Trump continues to challenge election results that have Joe Biden, the president-elect, Fox News has learned the government's intelligence assessment of foreign influence in the election will be delayed because of an internal dispute over how much China might have tried to meddle. An accused terrorist has been brought to the U.S., charged in a 9/11-style plot.
A Kenyan national has been indicted for conspiring to hijack an aircraft on behalf of the Al-Qaeda-affiliated terrorist organization Al-Shabaab. The indictment alleges Cholo Abdi Abdullah was an Al-Shabaab operative who participated in a plot to hijack a commercial aircraft and crash it into a building in the U.S. According to the indictment, beginning in 2016, while Abdullah was obtaining pilot training at a flight school, he also conducted research into the means and methods to hijack a commercial airliner to conduct the planned attack, including security on commercial airliners and how to breach a cockpit door from the outside. In Washington, John Decker, Fox News.
A trend this is. A Star Wars icon, now a Christmas star.
Wherever I go, he goes.
The holiday spirit is strong with this decoration. Fans of Disney's The Mandalorian are topping their Christmas trees with Baby Yoda figures. Instead of angels or stars, folks are posting photos of the child wearing antlers, Santa hats, or reaching out toward floating ornaments. The trend even inspiring YouTube tutorials on how to make your own Star Wars-centric topper. Baby Yoda becoming a pop culture star with the success of the series, inspiring a slew of memes and merchandise. Kristen Goodwin, Fox News.
On Wall Street, stock futures are rising up more than 100 points for the Dow the day after the Dow dropped 44, but the NASDAQ hit a record high yet again. I'm Dave Anthony. This is Fox News.
Are you looking for dental insurance? We've got you covered. With a dental plan from Emeritus, you have the freedom to choose your dentist. Network discounts keep your costs lower. Receive benefits right away with exams, cleanings, x-rays, and more covered 100% at day one. Contact the Owen Insurance Group at 772-210-1020, and we'll help you find a plan that's right for you today. Products underwritten by Emeritus Mutual Holding Company and subject to state availability and regulations.
Here's a quick tip. If you're ever stumped for a business you can trust, the Martin County Business Exchange has more than 70 companies you can count on for good service and fair prices. Whether it's for you, your house, or your office, get online at mcbiz.us. You'll find local businesses you can count on for quality, service, and fair prices. Visit mcbiz.us. Martin County Business Exchange. It's just good business.
The professionals at Mark Brechtel Certified Public Accountants are proud to sponsor Treasure Coast Solutions, a community service program designed to provide information you can use, a local perspective on national issues, local solutions to meet your individual concerns. At our firm, we believe that information is knowledge, and with knowledge comes the power to have a positive impact on our lives, businesses, schools, and community. If you would like one of our professionals to address your personal financial or business concerns, please give us a call to set up an appointment at 220-3380.
Coming to you live from Stuart, Florida, the greatest little town in the world, it's the Get Up and Go Show on AM 1450 WSTU. You're invited to call the show anytime at 772-220-9788. And now, broadcasting live from their palatial studios, here are your hosts, Evan and Bonnie.
.707 on the Get Up and Go Show, hour number two.
I'll smack you.
You better not smack me.
I am physically here, so that's something.
Oh, okay, well, I'm glad that you're, I'm glad that you're physically here.
Very nice.
That's right. We are about as nice as we can possibly humanly be just for you.
We are as nice as apple pie or pumpkin pie.
Merry Christmas to you and yours from all of us here at the Get Up and Go Show. We are exactly 1 week away from the big night when the big guy makes his rounds, where he says, on Donner, on Blitzen, on Cupid, on Snowy, on Kaya, on, oh, wait a minute, those are my dogs.
On Hansi and Jack Frosty.
Yeah, those are our pets. Oh, we can't forget Rudolph, too.
Yeah.
You've been naughty or nice? Well, if you've been nice, you'll get something nice for Christmas. If you've been naughty, well, you'll get something but not so nice.
A chunk of coal, right?
Yeah, but you'll still get something.
Is what they always left.
You'll still get something.
Something hard and kind of cold and something very unedible.
Yes, for sure. We have a phone call this morning. Let's go to the phones. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. And who do we have the pleasure of speaking with this morning?
Your wife.
Hey, what's up there, wife?
Do you know the name of Santa's reindeers?
No idea. I just know it's Donner, Blitzen, and Rudolph, and Dasher, and Prancer.
Did you say Donner?
Yeah.
Okay, he is one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Why do you know? Do you know the name of Santa's reindeer?
Sure do.
You do? All right, go ahead.
Dasher, Dancer, Prancer, Vixen, Comet, Cupid, Donner, Blitzen, Rudolph.
Oh, boy.
Did
well,
you learn
that's
that from,
what happens when you're a school teacher. You have to know these things.
Did you learn that from a childhood nursery rhyme? Is that something just kind of like etched in your memory from a long time ago?
Actually, it's the beginning of one, I don't remember who sings it, of Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, but it starts off.
Oh, is the one that goes, you'll know Donner, and
you know, Dasher and Dancer and Prancer.
That's the song, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Comet and Cupid and Donner and Blitzen.
So but you know when you singing on the air
when
now.
You can do it to song, I guess that's a good way to remember. And now that I think about the song and the way the Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer begins, it seems to me like I could name off the names too just by remembering that jingle.
So, how long did it take you to learn the names?
I don't know. I knew as long as I can remember. I must have learned this kid.
Oh, okay. Jeez. Well, maybe we should have a karaoke edition of Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer on the show this morning.
Maybe
and
not.
We could all sing. We could all sing the song. That would be possible.
Kind of take you back to your school days when you were a kid.
Right.
When they had
you
go. Sing it.
You know, Dasher and Dancer and Prancer and Vixen. Comet and Cupid and Donner
and Blitzen.
But do you recall
the most famous reindeer of all?
You're a little ahead.
Rachel, that wasn't too bad.
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Come on, Bonnie. Had a very shiny nose. And if you ever saw it.
You would even believe it close.
Oh, God, I can't believe we're singing on the radio this morning. Okay, all right, that's enough.
I did the William Shatner thing. I'm just going to, like, say the lyrics and not sing them.
There you go.
We don't want to lose any listeners.
Oh, we won't lose any listeners. Are you kidding? You have a concert coming up we're still waiting to go to.
Yeah.
Keeps getting postponed and put off.
Yeah, I've been working on that concert voice.
Yeah,
that's for sure.
Definitely so. So anyway, so what's on tap today? You have all that food that you baked last night at the house. Oh, my gosh. Rachel had, like, the baking factory going on.
Really?
And I'm starting my diet, and she's got, like, cookies galore she's baking last night.
You shouldn't be tempting Evan with that, Rachel.
Oh, man.
What's going on?
That's because today at work we have our cookie exchange, we have our potluck, we have our secret Santa.
Yeah,
we
she
have
makes
everything
these,
going on at work today.
She makes these sugar cookies with these... Hershey's peppermint kisses. In the top of them.
Ooh, those sound wonderful.
But you know what's really cool, though? When we went shopping yesterday, she bought this really cool, neat thing yesterday. And it makes hard-boiled eggs. And I was fascinated by it. See, like
only after he questioned why I was buying it.
Yeah, like the stupidest things.
Yeah.
Fascinate me the most.
Do they make the hard-boiled eggs quickly or more
yes.
quickly than...
What it is, it's a mini egg cooker. It's not a big one. It only cooks 7 eggs at a time.
Well, that's
yeah.
all right,
but
though.
I like I like making egg salad. Gavin likes eating hard-boiled eggs.
And I like deviled eggs.
Yeah, so I was like, okay, let me try it. I bought it because it was only like $9.
Yeah, it was cheap.
Yeah.
And well, that and they had like a mini donut maker, a mini waffle maker.
Yes, I was like, no. Just get the egg maker for
She's
now.
Getting all the Christmas
that's
presents
true,
early.
David.
Yeah.
Keep it up. I'll go back and buy them today.
Oh, boy. Here we go.
And so I got it home, and I started the cookies, and I was like, let me go ahead and mix some eggs. And this little thing, it's got a heating pan in it. It had a little measuring cup that you, depending on the type of egg you want, if you want it soft, if you wanted a medium or hard, and then one was called custard. And you fill water to the line and pour it in the heating pan. And then there's a little egg holder that goes on top. But on the bottom of your measuring cup, it had a, like a straight pin. So you could poke a hole in your egg.
Yeah.
You poked a hole in the fatter portion of the egg. And then when you put it up, you put the smaller side down so the hole was up. Then you put the cover on and you turn it on and it, the cooker itself, based on how much water you poured in, knew how long it had to cook.
You know, if it holds like 7 eggs, that's just like more than enough to make your deviled eggs because like you cut them in half anyway.
Right.
And then you have 14 deviled eggs. So that sounds terrific for only $9.
Yeah, and I mean, it took like 14 minutes to cook the eggs. But mm-hmm. then when I took them out, I put them in a bowl of water and ice and I let them sit for probably a little over 10 minutes. But then when I went to peel them, it was so easy to peel them.
Mm-hmm.
And then I ate 2 eggs and made egg salad and ate an egg salad sandwich last night. And then Gavin got home from church. He ate the other 5.
Hey, here's an idea, too, for like a sweet dip for your fruit, because I'm bringing a fruit tray, too, to work tomorrow morning. And
oh, you're bringing me fruit?
You know, I got to do it one of these mornings.
Okay.
But the dip is it's a sweet dip, perfect for dipping strawberries. I like mm-hmm. to dip the apples in it.
Mm-hmm.
And it's so easy. The easy ingredients, all you need is 8 ounces of Philadelphia cream cheese. And I think it was like 15 ounces of marshmallow fluff.
Oh, okay.
Mix that together. And it's a perfect sweet dip with strawberries. It's so good.
Oh, that sounds good. Hey, you know what tomorrow is? It's Friday. It's my last day before I go on vacation along with the wife. But more so, it's our, you know how Ellen has her 12 days of giveaways?
Yeah.
Well, tomorrow's my 1 day of giveaway. Mine and Rachel's 1 day of giveaway for you.
Oh, boy.
Yeah,
oh,
we're bringing
yeah,
gifts
for
tomorrow.
Me.
Yeah, we're bringing you gifts tomorrow.
Oh, you guys didn't have to.
Well,
I mean,
you know,
really.
We just, we didn't spend a whole lot of money. It's
good.
But it's, they're really, they're little trinkets and little things that I think you'll, Rachel, what do you think? Do you think she's going to be really pleasantly pleased?
I think you like them. I picked most of them out.
Yeah, she got most of them. I picked one of them.
Yeah.
I picked one, and Rachel got the rest.
So we have kind of a lady's taste with
them. Yeah, we do. We have,
we
have a female taste with the majority of
them.
Yeah,
and
yes.
To get my guy side, you know, like when I turn into Samuel.
Samuel!
Evan covered
that. I forgot about that. Your alter ego. Yeah. Yes, I bought you a razor for your face. Anyway, all right, we're going to run because we got to get to some birthdays and anniversaries. Have a great day. And
oh, I got to wish somebody a happy birthday.
Oh, okay. Oh, I know who we're talking about. Go ahead.
Who do you think we're talking about?
Darren.
Well, Darren, too, but no.
Who?
My BFF, Tammy.
Oh, Tammy Bolf.
Yes, today is her birthday.
Oh, I wonder if she's listening. Probably not.
She's probably still sleeping. Well, yeah, she might be sleeping.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah, she's up in, what city is she in?
I don't know. It's north of Orlando.
Okay, uh-huh. Somewhere up there. But anyway, Tammy's, she's in her 40s now. She got a couple of kids.
Nice.
Lives on a big piece of property.
I've known Tammy since I was 10.
Wow.
Yeah, that was Rachel's maid of honor
uh-huh.
at the wedding.
Nice.
Yep.
Yep.
Grew up with one
and
another,
it's
too.
It's also Taylor McCain's birthday.
Oh, is it really Taylor's birthday?
Yep, it's her birthday, too.
Oh, wow. Okay. Tay-Tay. That's Gavin used to call her Tay-Tay, his little Tay-Tay. All right. So, well, happy birthday to Taylor McCain and to Tammy Bolf.
Yep.
All right. Well, I will see you a little later.
Have a great day, guys.
All right. Bye-bye.
Enjoy your day.
Well, the man himself, Manny Pacquiao, 42 years old today. That's the dazzling Filipino boxer. He's celebrating a birthday today. Bonnie, do you have any birthdays, by the way?
Oh, I don't. Nobody to wish a happy birthday to today.
You know whose birthday it is today? Somebody you haven't even noticed that's been staring at you for the last hour and a half.
This elf on the shelf?
Yeah, the elf on the shelf. It's his birthday today.
Oh, did he come
Swag
to your...
Swag's birthday.
Did he come to your home like 2 years ago or something?
Well, he came many years ago.
Two today?
Many years ago.
Like how old would Swag be?
I know. Swag is like 7 or 8 or 10
yeah,
or something like that.
He looks about to be 7-ish.
Yeah.
So I'll take
He's kind of hanging out on your mic stand today. I came in this morning. I saw him there. I'm like, how the heck did he get there? I have no
he
idea.
He doesn't even bother me anymore. I used to be freaked out by the little elf.
I honestly think that... I don't know. I mean, he's magical. He moves around. He's only going to be here one more day.
You know what would really freak me out, Evan?
What?
If he blinked his eyelids at me.
Really?
If he could magically do that somehow, that would be kind of a freak right now.
Wow. Okay.
Put the freak in Christmas.
Put the freak. All right. Very good. Sarah Paulson, 46 years old today. That's from American Horror Story. Rian Johnson, 47. That's the director of Star Wars. Lori Holden's 51. Chuck Liddell, 51 also. That's the former UFC light heavyweight champion. Tracy Byrd. Tracy Byrd, country music artist. 10 rounds of Jose Cuervo. That's one of his big tunes.
Yep. He's just a little bit younger than you today.
54.
Turning 54.
Yeah, 54
country
today.
Country music superstar.
Bill Pullman, 67. That's Detective Ambrose on the center. Ernie Hudson, 75 years old today. That's Winston in Ghostbusters. And Pope Francis, 84 years old today.
Wow.
Today is National Maple Syrup Day. National Maple Syrup Day.
I love some maple syrup. You know, my brother made it up in northern Wisconsin,
mm-hmm.
and he sent me some down one year.
Yeah.
And he got the sap. He did it right out of, like, you would get the sap right out of a
tree.
Right
out of the tree?
Right out of the tree.
Very interesting.
I think he had a couple of that. He might have even gotten them out of in his very own front yard.
Okay.
But that year, I'll tell you what, he sent it to me right around Christmas time,
uh-huh.
and that maple syrup went over my Christmas ham that year.
Oh, wow.
And oh boy, did it taste sweet.
Very, very nice. Very, very nice. 7:20 right now on the Get Up and Go show. It's news time. Let's head over to the news desk. Bonnie's standing by. Good morning, Bonnie.
Good morning, Evan. Indian River State College has received the largest donation in its history, $45 million, putting it among nearly 400 organizations getting donations from philanthropist McKinsey Scott. The donation was announced Wednesday. In the past 4 months, Scott has given nearly $4.2 billion to 384 organizations across all 50 states. She said Tuesday in a Medium post, the donation donation to IRSC will support initiatives at the college, such as growing career training and degree programs, according to the college. Some school districts in our area are now reaching out to Tallahassee and asking Florida Governor Ron DeSantis to make teachers a priority for the COVID-19 vaccine. Here's WPTV's Ryan Hughes.
For 18 years, Chris Waldrop has been teaching students, but he says balancing in-person instruction and virtual learning has been his biggest challenge during the pandemic at St. Lucie West Centennial High School.
There'll be times where, like, my physical class will have 26 students in it, and then all of a sudden there's a quarantine list sent out and like 10 of those kids are gone.
St. Lucie School Superintendent Wayne Jent says he expects more students to return to the classroom after winter break and is now having conversations about the COVID-19 vaccine and getting educators vaccinated.
So that is a priority for us to make sure that when the next batch comes out, that those that have direct contact with students are included.
Jen says he will take the vaccine, but it would be voluntary for teachers and staff.
This will be just one less thing that needs to be worried about by our instructors, our teachers, our bus drivers.
Here in Martin County, the school board voted Tuesday night to send a formal request to Governor Ron DeSantis asking district employees with direct contact with students to be considered a priority to receive the vaccine.
The governor has said he expects the Johnson & Johnson vaccine to receive approval after the new year. And on Tuesday in West Palm Beach, the governor said it's expected to only require one dose.
That makes it easier to do on a mass scale because you can go and in a school district can offer to the teachers one shot and you don't have to worry about going back.
Waldrop does not want to be pushed to the front of the line, but says he does want the vaccine.
I hope people would understand the importance of getting the vaccine so that we can all be healthy and, you know, live somewhat of a normal life again.
Ryan Hughes, WPTV, News Channel 5.
The wait is almost over for seniors across the state anticipating their coronavirus vaccine and a little piece of freedom.
Over the next week, state and other experts will visit more than 100 long-term care facilities in Broward, Miami-Dade, and Pinellas counties armed with vials of the valuable vaccine. CVS and Walgreens staffers could begin administering their 60,000 doses Monday. Florida Emergency Management Director Jared Moskowitz says these facilities have been struck with more than COVID.
It was isolation. It was being disconnected from their family members. It was not being able to have visitors. And so this is the beginning of the end to all of that.
Once the Moderna vaccine is approved, more than 350,000 doses of it will be shipped to Florida hospitals. Erica Rodriguez, Miami.
The coronavirus vaccine is already being administered to Florida's frontline healthcare workers.
I got mine at the beginning of my shift, and I felt fine. A little bit sore in my arm now, but other than that, I felt good. I got through my shift.
Yes.
In Orlando, Advent Health nurse manager Sue Upper says a line of doctors stretched into the lobby as they queued up to get the vaccine. Advent Health received its first shipment of 20,000 vaccine doses earlier this week. A woman says a Detroit family doctor fathered hundreds of babies, which included her. The woman says she took a DNA test and traced it back to her family's doctor. Jamie Hall says Dr. Peven, who's now 104, admitted to fathering her and potentially hundreds of others, and says it was a group of doctors who were doing this for decades. I think my mom's doctor is my dad, Hall said. The woman says she couldn't believe it when she took a DNA test through Ancestry.com. The results came back to her family doctor being the person who fathered her. Hall says she wasn't the only person who took a test. Shortly after, she received a call from a half-brother. She says her parents, who have both died, had no idea Dr. Peven used his own sperm. They went to Grace Hospital in Detroit in the 50s because they were having a difficult time conceiving. Hall says Dr. Peven would inseminate his parents with a fresh sperm sample from himself or one of the other doctors. Hall says she believes Dr. Peven was more of a scientist and a doctor second. And lastly, SpaceX is set to launch a spy satellite into orbit for the U.S. National Reconnaissance Office this morning. The flight is scheduled to blast off from Pad 39A at Kennedy Space Center during a planned three-hour window that opens at 9 a.m. However, the exact liftoff time has not yet been announced. Small businesses are struggling big time during the pandemic, and an NBA player has a creative idea to help them out. Larry Nance Jr. of the Cleveland Cavaliers shared his address on social media and asked his followers to buy a piece of apparel from any of their favorite local businesses and send it to him. He wears a size extra large shirt. And he said, quote, "I will wear each piece of apparel to a game this year, be photographed, and post about that business to help bring awareness." And if that wasn't enough, he made it clear that all apparel he receives after being supported and acknowledged will be donated back to local area homeless shelters. Now that is very cool. Our news time is 7:26. We'll have weather and traffic together next.
Who respond 24/7, and there are flexible payment options for metal, tile, shingle, or flat roofs. Code Red Roofers. Se habla español. Code Red Roofers. 844-4 Code Red. That's 844-4 Code Red.
. 727 on the Get Up and Go Show with Evan and Bonnie. It's time for traffic and weather together. Of course, it's all brought to you by Code Red Roofers. Bonnie?
Well, Evan, there is an accident on I-95 northbound up in Port St. Lucie. This is northbound on mile marker 117. There's not any roadblocks, so traffic still moving through there, at least. Now, if you're heading south on I-95 southbound, however, there is an accident down at Donald Ross Road. This is southbound and some slowdown. Two right lanes are blocked in that area this morning. There's your latest look at traffic. It's 70 in Port St. Lucie. In Nagasaki, Japan, a clear sky in 36. Here's our forecast at WPTV.
It is going to be a relatively warm morning along the Treasure Coast. We've got some clouds overhead. Also, chance for some patchy fog, too. We will see a stray sprinkle possible early, but a better chance of some isolated downpours into the late morning and early afternoon hours. Temperatures still going to climb into the low and middle 70s for your afternoon high temperatures. As we look toward tonight, that cold front moves on through. Jacket weather does return. I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Harrison Hove on WSTU AM 1450, Martin County's Heritage Station.
By avoiding the three C's, closed spaces, crowded places, and close contact. Protect yourself and others by wearing a mask, social distancing, and washing your hands. And please, stay home if you're sick so you don't share your germs with others. Learn more at martincountyhealth.com.
Unfortunately, in today's litigious society, too many Americans fail to have an effective estate plan and asset protection strategy. I'm attorney TJ Heineman, and I've been counseling families, businesses, and executives for 20 years. I can help you preserve your wealth, safeguard your assets, and protect your family. My law firm specializes in estate planning and administration, asset protection, corporate law, and real estate. For a free copy of my Family Estate Planning Survival Guide or a free consultation in my Palm City office, call me, TJ Heineman, at 888-5667.
So, have you heard this one? A priest and a rabbi come into this radio station. Really, it's a priest and a rabbi. Right here, Friday mornings beginning at 9, here on WSTU AM 1450. Bring your questions and join their lively conversation with Father Christian from St. Mary's Episcopal Church and Rabbi Matt Durbin from the Temple Beit Hayim. It's a priest and a rabbi, Friday mornings at 9 here on WSTU.
Fuel your real
opening with the power of talk radio. WPFL and WSTU Digital on TuneIn Worldwide and on Alexa at home, car, tablet, or phone.
You're listening to the Get Up and Go Show with Evan and Bonnie on Martin County's Heritage Station, AM 1450 WSTU. Now let's get back to the program with Evan and Bonnie.
.7:31 on the Get Up and Go Show, feeling very festive today because today's a very special day. The reason I say that is because coming up at 8 o'clock, it's the Martin and Stuart Chamber of Commerce Morning Joe that Bonnie and I are going to be invading. We do it once a month.
Yeah.
Right, Bonnie?
Yeah, we're going to be inviting everybody tuning in, zooming in with us this
morning. Yeah, we're going to take over the Morning Joe.
To maybe look for some holiday items.
Yeah, we're going to have fun. And we're going to be asking for all sorts of weird, strange holiday items this year.
Yeah.
And boy, I've got a good one.
And maybe not
I just thought of a good one.
Maybe not only weird and strange, but kind of cool,
yeah, cool
items for the holiday.
Too.
Can you reveal the one that you just thought of?
No. Because if Joe's not at work, he may just happen to find this item and bring it to work, and then he'll be the first to show it on screen.
Oh, yeah, we can't give out any hints.
No hints on this one. But joining us on the line right now is the gentleman that heads up that wonderful, wonderful organization, the Martin Stuart Chamber of Commerce, the president himself, the man that you really needs no introduction, Mr. Joe Catrombone. Joe, good morning. How are you?
Good morning, guys. How are you?
Oh, you know, just, geez. I'm excited about today.
Yeah, we're looking forward to it. We had fun, certainly, last month. That was great. Everybody's still talking about it. And by the way, I am sitting at my desk, so there's no. I won't be running around going through my drawers looking for items that y'all might conjure up.
Gotcha.
For them to come up with.
Gotcha. So last night, you guys had your mixer. I was not able to attend because I had some other things that I needed to get done. I was planning on going, and I couldn't make it. So tell me about last night. How did that go?
It was really nice. It was different. You know, this is Hutchinson Island Marriott does it for us every year. Next year is already booked. I mean, it's like automatic. And so it's our Christmas business after hours, and we usually attract over 200. We had over 100 this year, which surprised me because that's certainly the largest turnout of any event we've had so far.
Mm-hmm.
We've been averaging like our lunches maybe 60 to 70, our breakfast 50 to 60.
Okay.
So this was, again, we had well over 100, I'd say about 110 people.
Wow.
Normally they have a slicing station, and they have sushi bar, and they have... what they do is they go above and beyond. But for the first time ever, they had servers. So the tables were behind plexiglass.
Mm-hmm.
And it was typical, you know, they had servers behind there, whatever you wanted, you asked the waitress or the waiter for, and they put it on a plate for you. So it was a little different than normal, but still a huge success. Everybody... understood and appreciated, even though it's outside poolside.
Right.
A large number of it's obviously it's difficult to practice social distancing, but we're outside. But almost always, and everyone wore a mask. So it was well done, and I think everybody felt safe. Obviously. If you were eating or drinking, you had your mask in your hand. But while you're networking, which is what that is really all about, with people networking, I was surprised everyone had their masks on and tried their best to social distance. Again, we certainly weren't 6 feet apart, that's for sure. But again, everyone had their masks on, and it went very well. And they're such gracious hosts and such great community. They're a great corporate community citizen. They always have been. As you know, they've been there for a long, long time.
Right.
And so it really went well. I was pleasantly surprised.
I'm sure everybody just wanted to get out and really enjoy finally that good Hutchinson Island fresh air.
Oh yeah, definitely.
Yeah, it was, and it was beautiful at poolside, you know. And it's funny, you know, like I said, it's our annual holiday business after hours, and I can remember years where we were, you know, they had heaters out there.
Right.
It was so cold. Yeah. And I think last year it was so hot, it was like a sauna.
Oh, my.
It was really nice. The weather was good. I obviously had a suit jacket on, and I wasn't overheated or too hot. So it was a perfect evening. It was really nice.
Very, very nice. Very nice. I'm glad it all went very well. And my apologies for not making it. Just, something came up. I needed to take care of some business.
I apologize, too, Joe. We were supposed to make it out there.
I know you were. I got an email from Evan, so I knew he wasn't coming. But I told the staff to watch out for you. And so, but anyway, listen, we understand. You all are busy, and we all are.
We're in high demand, Joe. You know, our show's so popular. Everybody,
I know that.
You know, everybody wants us, and it's just so hard to, you know, split us up in many different ways.
But let us know when your next event is, please, especially if you're serving sushi. I'll be there.
Oh, yeah, sure. Oh, you'll only go for the sushi, right, Bonnie?
I heard that sushi a couple of weeks ago, man, and I was like,
so great. But most of our business after hours are not as elaborate. And in fact, none are as elaborate as they do it. But we have a lot of events coming up. Caitlin is working overtime, boy. She's really, and we'll talk about that later. I mean,
she's a busy girl. She's got that. She's working overtime. She's planning a wedding. Oh my gosh, she's got so much going on.
And we've got our events booked through March.
Wow.
So she's, and you know, and I was telling someone about it. Yeah, in fact, I guess I told her we had a board meeting yesterday. As you know, we had to let four people go. We went from a 9-person staff to a 5-person staff, and everybody is. We haven't missed a beat. Everybody's stepped up, working a little harder and working a little longer. And I know I was in Saturday, and one of them was in Saturday catching up on some stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So, but Caitlin has absorbed probably more of the overflow than anyone else because she is an events coordinator. And events, for instance, I'll mention it, of course, while I mention it right now, our health and wellness show, which was scheduled for January, because of lack of interest, we rescheduled that till May. So we have those kinds of things going on. Where right now she would be going full blast getting ready for the show at the mall in January. So that's not till May now. So anyway.
Now, is that show going to be at the mall?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I have somebody for you that you should talk to in regards to that. I don't know if they're a member or not, but we'll, you know, reach out to me after 11 o'clock this morning and I'll give you their information. In regards to helping you with that and possibly coming on as a sponsor.
Okay, that'd be great.
Yeah, most definitely. So what's new at the Chamber? Do we have any new businesses that signed up last week?
We do, but I'll get to those in a minute.
Okay.
Evan, this time of the year, people are planning their holiday, they're planning trips. There, you know, and so usually this is really a down time for us. But I think we brought four or five new members in this week. So, you know, again, an indication that things are going in the right direction. We just have to keep our fingers crossed and keep hoping it goes in the right direction. We just finished our second month of our fiscal year. We're running about 25% ahead of projection.
Okay.
And that's just for October and November. And I already know that we're going to exceed projections in December. I already know that. So, you know, things are obviously looking extremely well. We're very fortunate here in Martin County. And on the Treasure Coast, as a matter of fact, I know the other chambers are doing pretty good, too. So we're fortunate. I say it's a little bubble we're in because if you look south of us, they're hurting.
Yeah, and you go north and they're hurting, too.
Yeah, so we're very fortunate to be where we're at. And, in this wonderful place we call the Treasure Coast.
So what are the new businesses that we have that signed up? Please let us know.
Okay, let's go. We have chefs for seniors. They're in Stuart.
Chefs Amanda, for seniors. That sounds very interesting.
Yeah, Amanda Jones is the owner.
Okay.
And, they do catering and personal chef bartending, and they do cater parties and things of that nature.
Okay.
If the client's on Medicare, Medicare pays for the service, and the client only pays for a grocery store list. So it's a pretty nice service. They're obviously filling a need on taking advantage of a Medicare option, an opportunity. And then we had Nina Ferreira, who's an attorney. She's in Stuart on Central Parkway.
Okay.
She does mostly real estate law and estate planning, title insurance, that type of stuff. Harbor Chase, I think we spoke about them last week. They're the new senior living place by the Rose at the foot of the Roosevelt Bridge.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
They were a member, just a regular member, and they stepped up to become a trustee member, which is that's a whole new category for them. So we're welcoming them into that into the trustee program.
Yeah, I pass them every morning, Joe. It looks like a really beautiful place.
Oh, it is. It is really done.
Oh, I bet it looks very posh from the outside.
It really is. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And then we had Shearwater Marine. Jim Draxeth has been, Jim's been around for a long time. Kind of stepped away from the marine industry. Now he's back in it again with Shearwater Marine. They're on Commerce Avenue in Stuart. They do marine diesel and gas repair engines, and they obviously sell marine equipment. Do a lot of marine electronics. Ocean One Stuart, Shannon Glendening. Is her name, and she's a real estate and commercial broker. So, pretty good week for us and for Amy. And we have a short week next week, and she got appointments next week, believe it or not, making sales calls next week on Christmas week. Unbelievable.
Very nice, very nice. Joe, I'm going to be on vacation next week, so that we'll have we won't be having our weekly meeting, and then we'll resume back the last week of the year with our final update from the Martin Stuart Chamber of Commerce, our very special guest.
That'd be on, I guess, on New Year's Eve, the 31st.
Yes.
And so we're closed. I won't be in the office most likely, but you can.
Yeah, I'll call your cell phone. Sure. Your cell phone. Not a problem. We'll do that.
Okay.
Our very special guest has been the president, the gentleman that heads up the. Stuart Martin Chamber of Commerce. Joe Catrombone has been joining us right now. Joe, give out your information if people want to get a hold of you in their business. That's really super important.
It is. Thank you for that. 772-287-1088. My extension is 108. Or our website is stuartmartinchamber.org.
Okay, very good, very good. Tell everybody to start getting their... scavenger hunt items ready because we're going to have some fun in the morning, Joe, a little bit after 8 o'clock this morning.
Okay. Well, I'll look forward to seeing you in a little bit.
All right. We'll talk to you in a little bit.
Okay, guys. All right.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye now. I cannot wait for that one. Oh, my gosh. I'm going to have so much fun.
As you said, you thought of one more. I thought of one more, too. I wonder if it's the same one. Wouldn't it be funny if we were both on the same page and thought of it?
Let's just say it has to do with right there, okay? The Christmas spirit.
Right there.
Right there in the Christmas
Mine
spirit.
Mine has to do with what's right here in
right.
the Christmas
Oh, okay,
spirit.
That's a good one. Okay, all right, very good. All right.
Only we this can
gonna,
see the hints.
Yeah, this is going to be interesting. It's 7:45 on the Get Up and Go Show with Evan and Bonnie. Let's go to the news desk. Here is Bonnie.
Thank you, Evan. And months away from a COVID-19 vaccine for the general public, and there is new guidance for pregnant women and for nursing mothers.
As 2020 comes to a close and we get closer to a COVID-19 vaccine becoming available, many expecting mothers and women who are nursing will have a decision to make. Whatever the decision, the American College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists says the vaccine should not be withheld from them.
All smiles this holiday season, the Arriero Fajeras in Jupiter are nearing the end of a pregnancy in a pandemic.
We've been really hardcore about just isolation and staying away from people.
Elizabeth is due in January, and even though the COVID-19 vaccine won't be available for now, she, like many other women building a family, has a lot to consider.
Because we do plan to have one more kid ultimately, I do want to wait a little while to get one myself.
This week, the American College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists published an article saying pregnant women and lactating mothers should not be excluded from getting a COVID-19 vaccine.
To me, it doesn't mean that we need to run out there and enroll all our pregnant patients to get the vaccine.
Board certified OBGYN Dr. Colette Brown Graham says pregnant and nursing women should discuss the vaccine with their doctors and know the risks of not getting it.
If you are pregnant and you get COVID, there is a higher chance that you will get mechanical ventilation. There's a higher chance that you will go into an ICU.
Dr. Brown Graham points out the makeup of the vaccine is messenger RNA, which does not change DNA. Still, with no pregnant women included in the trials, she says she will be on the lookout for new data, but adds there is another alternative.
If everyone around the pregnant patient or pregnant person has gotten the vaccine, we're essentially creating a herd immunity for that pregnant patient.
Elizabeth agrees creating a cocoon of vaccinated relatives around her and the baby may be the safest option.
We're just excited for the little one to get here and you know, continue what we've been doing to stay healthy and safe.
Michelle Quesada, WPTV News Channel 5.
Another 122 deaths in Florida are blamed on the coronavirus. The Department of Health also announcing yesterday that new cases exceeded 11,000. The wait is almost over for seniors across the state anticipating their coronavirus vaccine and a little piece of freedom.
Over the next week, state and other experts will visit more than 100 long-term care facilities in Broward, Miami-Dade, and Pinellas counties armed with vials of the valuable vaccine. CVS and Walgreens staffers can begin administering their 60,000 doses Monday. Florida Emergency Management Director Jared Moskowitz says these facilities have been struck with more than COVID.
It was isolation. It was being disconnected from their family members. It was not being able to have visitors. And so this is the beginning of the end to all of that.
Once the Moderna vaccine is approved, more than 350,000 doses of it will be shipped to Florida hospitals. Erica Rodriguez, Miami.
Disney Cruise Line is canceling all cruises until March. The company made that announcement yesterday, citing coronavirus concerns. Guests booked on affected sailings who have paid their reservations in full will be offered the choice of a cruise credit or a full refund. Dozens of buildings are damaged after a tornado ripped through Pinellas County. It also hit Hillsborough and Polk counties, beginning just before 4 yesterday afternoon. The National Weather Service says the twister covered over 50 miles in 2 hours. So far, no injuries have been reported. And lastly, do you remember Night Court? Well, a Night Court sequel series is coming with John Larroquette returning as attorney Dan Fielding. Original star Harry Anderson died in 2018, so the show will be about his character's daughter, who's also a Night Court judge. Baltimore Ravens quarterback Lamar Jackson believes there is a connection between his cramping on Monday night and his bout with COVID-19 over the past month. Asked Wednesday if the cramping was related to having the coronavirus recently, Jackson said, probably because of the body heat and we're running in the cold. It was so cold out there that probably had an effect on that as well. I can't call it. Our news time is 7:49 and we'll have weather and traffic together next.
Into St. Lucie Jewelry and Coins, I figured it would just be one of my many stops on my road to the perfect engagement ring. My fiancé means the world to me, so I wanted something extra special. I found a huge selection of engagement rings at great prices, and my worry about finding the perfect engagement ring was quickly replaced with exceptional customer service. St. Lucie Jewelry's over 400 five-star reviews really told the story. I finally picked a ring, and it was perfect. She was floored. And then the tears came.
Hi,
This is Hawk Levy, owner of St. Lucie Jewelry and Coins. We're now celebrating 26 years, voted best diamond dealers, best jewelry buyers, and best jeweler year after year. Come celebrate with us in opening our third location at 1335 St. Lucie West Boulevard next to Publix. We invite you to take a tour of our competition, but then come see us last.
.750, the time right now, the Get Up and Go Show with Evan and Bonnie. It's time for traffic and weather together, all brought to you by Code Red Roofers. Bonnie?
If you're heading south on I-95 this morning, you might see some slowdown tie-up down by Donald Ross Road, I-95 southbound. There is an accident and some roadblock, too. Two right lanes down that way are blocked this morning. And to the north of us, I-95 northbound in Port St. Lucie, at mile marker 117, there is an accident. However, no roadblock from the accident. Yeah, you should be able to move smoothly, easily through there, okay. That's your latest look at traffic. Right now we have 72 in Palm City and 30 this morning in St. John's, Canada. Here's our weather at WPTV.
It is going to be relatively warm morning along the Treasure Coast. We've got some clouds overhead. Also, chance for some patchy fog, too. We will see a stray sprinkle possible early, but a better chance of some isolated downpours into the late morning and early afternoon hours. Temperatures still going to climb into the low and middle 70s for your afternoon high temperatures. As we look toward tonight, that cold front moves on through. Jacket weather does return.
I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Harrison Hove on WSTU AM 1450, Martin County's Heritage Station.
With my Florida insurance broker, and I'm here today with my daughter Sage.
Hello.
Sage, why don't you tell everybody what kind of insurance we do?
Home insurance, car insurance, life insurance, and flood insurance.
If you've had a rate hike or two or five, hopefully not 10, give us a call. We'd love to hear from you. Sage, what's our number?
772-617-6777.
What's the name of our company again?
My Florida Insurance Broker.
The Slim Body Laser Spa, the wait is over.
What are you waiting for? Call the Slim Body Laser Spa and Stuart today and start losing inches today. That's right, lose belly fat, your double chin, flabby thighs, upper arm fat. Well, you get the picture. In a short series of laser-assisted weight loss treatments, you can lose inches of unwanted fat. Call 223-5885.
The Slim Body Laser Spa, the wait is over.
Weight, feel great and look fantastic with a little help from Dr. Fred J. Rezacker of Slim Body Laser Spa, East Ocean Boulevard in Stuart. And they're online. Visit their website, slimbodylaser.com. In a few short treatments, you'll see results. Lose 3, 6, even 9 inches of unwanted belly fat. The wait is over. Call today, 223-5885. That's 223-5885.
The Slim Body Laser Spa, the wait is over.
Experience Heatco Botanical Gardens in Fort Pierce in a whole new light at the 6th Annual Garden of Lights. Be dazzled by thousands of lights crafted in whimsical garden designs. This is an outdoor event and masks are required. There will be refreshments and a holiday photo op with Heatcoat the Bear. The evening event kicks off Thanksgiving weekend and runs through New Year's. For tickets and more information, visit heatcoatbotanicalgardens.org.
Today in Ag News, I'm a Southeast Ag Dad. Well, one Southeast University Extension economist does not believe prices will climb much higher in the foreseeable future for cotton. Clint Thompson has the story.
Southeast cotton producers have experienced an unpredictable season with regard to market prices this year. The market plunged to 52 cents per pound not long after COVID-19 struck in mid-March. But over the next 9 months, prices have surged back over 70 cents. Adam Rabinowitz, assistant professor and extension economist at Auburn University, is hesitant to believe prices will climb much higher in the foreseeable future.
Where I'm seeing a little bit of the surprise is, I think, you know, we're looking at close to 75 cents a pound right now for cotton, and I think that's probably hitting about a a high point, unless we have some significant market changes in the next 2 months.
There's also a belief cotton acreage could drop next season, especially with how well soybean prices are currently doing. This could impact cotton prices as well.
Well, yeah, I think at least until the start of the new year, I think it will hold steady. It's going to be interesting to see what the expected acreage will be for next year in terms of production. But I would expect to see price probably closer to 70 cents a pound for next year.
For more information, see southeastagnet.com. For Southeast Agnet, I'm Clint Thompson.
Are you stuck inside but looking for bargains on new and secondhand goods? Try HiBid.com, the online auction site for just about anything. HiBid.com offers a safe and easy way to find hundreds of thousands of items for sale every day. From rare coins to fine jewelry, tools to vintage toys, and classic cars to real estate, HiBid.com has it all. HiBid.com makes it easy to find what you're looking for, and the site is simple to use. Come to HiBid.com, that's HIBID.com, and start discovering great deals today.
Randall Wiseman, Southeast Agnet.
If you have a suggestion for the show, we would love to hear from you. Send us an email to WSTUmorningshow@gmail.com. Now let's get back to the Get Up and Go show. Here's Evan and Bonnie.
As the pandemic rages on, Americans are missing yet another time-honored holiday tradition. The office party. That one magic night to get drunk in your cubicle. It'll have to wait another year. Or does it? Introducing the Office Party Party Box. Everything you need to have a corporate celebration in the safety of home. Each Office Party Party Box includes eggnog, no-name rum, and a premium red plastic cup. Carol's just above room temperature deviled eggs. And enough weed for a single hit in the third floor bathroom. Side effects may include DWIs, HR violations, or Angela the receptionist impregnation.
Okay, so coming up in just a little bit, Bonnie, this is going to be exciting. We're going to be invading the Morning Joe.
They look like they're having a party over there already at Morning Joe.
Yeah, I'm going to be logging in here on the this machine here so they can see me and everything.
Oh, you know what? With that last advertisement, too, that we just played, Evan, that gave me another idea of perhaps what they can go and find.
Okay, well, don't give anything away, because now they can hear us.
Okay.
Yeah, they can hear, especially Caitlin. She's sneaky.
This one would involve your refrigerator, though.
Yeah, definitely. I see you're giving stuff away.
Yeah, but that's kind of like a fair hint for everyone, because everybody should be near, maybe at home, near a refrigerator anyway. Okay. So maybe that one was okay.
Well, don't give nothing away. Okay. We're gonna ask the folks that are in the Zoom call just to kind of keep on the quiet side right now, because I have to bring the channel up that they're all logged in on, just to test the audio with some music here. So everybody that's listening, don't say anything at all whatsoever. Anyway, we're gonna let this play out all the way until the news. So we'll say that we're WSTU Stuart. We're Martin County's Heritage Station. The news is coming up next, and then we get to invade the Stuart Martin Chamber of Commerce's Morning Joe.
And they get to invade us, our radio waves, too.
That's right.
Here.
It's going to be a lot of fun. We're WSTU Stuart. We're Martin County's Heritage Station. The news is coming up next. Don't you go anywhere.
this pandemic. I'm Dave Anthony, Fox News. Almost 250,000 new coronavirus cases yesterday in the U.S. More than 3,600 deaths, both are records, and the number of COVID patients in hospitals at an all-time high again.
We knew reality for a disease like this is that we would continue to see surges. It is unfortunate we're seeing this surge so strongly here.
But Deputy Health and Human Services Secretary Eric Hargan told the Fox News Rundown podcast, vaccines are the light at the end of the tunnel. The second one gets the FDA spotlight today. Fox's Evan Brown has more live.
Yeah, Dave, the FDA's Vaccine and Related Biological Products Advisory Committee meets again today, and they will be debating both the immediate need and effectiveness of Moderna's candidate coronavirus vaccine. The committee could vote tonight to recommend an emergency use authorization. The process will be similar to last week's review of Pfizer's vaccine, which got a green light by Friday night and now is being used to inoculate frontline medical workers and nursing home residents. The Trump administration says they're on schedule to vaccinate 20 million Americans by New Year's, Dave.
And Evan, the White House Task Force Dr. Anthony Fauci telling Americans not to travel for the holidays. A months-long standoff over Corona financial aid in Congress may finally end.
We are close to an agreement. It's not a done deal yet, but we are very close.
Democratic Senate Leader Chuck Schumer, the bill being worked out would include extra and extended unemployment pay, more small business loans, and more direct payments for Americans who qualify. Still stormy this morning in the east, getting hit from North Carolina to Maine. Tens of thousands lost power in Virginia because of icy buildups on tree branches.
That increased weight, the trees can't really handle that, and they just tend to snap or break.
He's a utility worker in Charlottesville. Some areas getting 1 to 2 to 3 feet of snow. Two people were killed on a Pennsylvania highway when dozens of vehicles crashed. America's listening to Fox News.
At Fisher Investments, we do things differently, and other money managers don't understand why.
Because our way works great for us.
But it may not work for your clients. That's why Fisher Investments is a fiduciary, obligated to put clients first. It's the highest standard for a financial advisor.
So, what do you provide? Cookie-cutter portfolios like the rest of us?
No cookie-cutter portfolios here. Fisher Investments tailors portfolios to meet each client's goals and needs.
Well, you do sell investments that earn you high commissions, right? And make commissions when you make trades for your clients?
No, Fisher Investments doesn't sell any commission investment products, and we never earn commissions on trades.
So what's in it for you?
Fisher Investments fees are structured so we do better when our clients do better. When it comes to helping clients achieve a comfortable retirement, we're clearly different. Visit FisherInvestments.com to find out why investors like you switch to us. Fisher Investments, clearly different money management.
Investments in securities involve the risk of loss.
Senate Republicans shine a light on the election. Homeland Security Committee Chairman Ron Johnson, a Republican, led a hearing.
A large percentage of the American public does not believe the November election results are legitimate.
Witnesses testified about irregularities in different states, but Democratic Senator Gary Peters called it a dangerous hearing.
The president and many of his supporters are, unfortunately, continuing their efforts to undermine the will of the people, disenfranchise voters, and sow the seeds of mistrust and discontent to further their partisan desire for power.
A former cop is in trouble in Texas after trying to uncover election fraud.
In the closing weeks of the 2020 election, prosecutors in Houston say former police captain Mark Anthony Aguirre claimed a voter fraud scheme was underway and that a group of private citizens was conducting an investigation. But court documents now show he's accused of running a repairman off the road and pinning him to the ground at gunpoint, convinced there were hundreds of thousands of fraudulent ballots in the man's truck. Instead, only air conditioning equipment was found, and Aguirre was paid over $200,000 by the Houston-based Liberty Center for God and Country the day after the incident. Aguirre was arrested this week and charged with aggravated assault with a deadly weapon, facing up to 20 years in prison if convicted. Lisa Brady, Fox News.
Later this hour, we'll get the weekly update on how many people filed jobless claims. In California, fraud.
Prosecutors say Kara Kirk Connell used the dark web to purchase stolen identities, then watched YouTube videos to learn how to file fake unemployment claims. She now faces up to 10 years in prison after pleading guilty. Prosecutors say Kirk Connell obtained over $500,000 in COVID-19-related unemployment funds through the state of California. She had already spent nearly $270,000 of that.
That's Tom Rigotti. I'm Dave Anthony, and this is Fox News.
As
we work to reopen the economy, a renaissance has begun in the world of investing. And if you're retired or within 10 years of retirement and your current advisor isn't prepared for the new corona economy, it could lead to costly mistakes you cannot afford to make at this point in your life. We're the Retirement Income Store, and our message is clear. It's time to stop crossing your fingers, hoping for growth in the stock market. There is another more conservative way to plan for income without all the risk, using interest and dividends. Call the Retirement Income Store today at 800-211-5872 for your free, no-obligation retirement income kit, including five educational tools.
That's 800-211-5872.
The Retirement Income Store, where retirees go for income.
That's 800-211-5872.
Are you looking for a career with good pay and growth opportunities? Then register today for Indian River State College's Certified Logistics Associate Training Program. Hi, I'm Joe Gorham with IRSC's Corporate Community Training Institute. The CLA course provides students with the foundational broad knowledge you will need to understand the world of distribution. The course includes training in the global supply chain, logistics environment, safe equipment operation, material handling equipment, quality control, workplace communication, teamwork, and problem solving. Upon completion, students will have the opportunity to earn a nationally recognized industry certification. Start your career path today and earn more in the dynamic field of distribution for companies like Amazon, Walmart, CVS, and others. For more information on the Lincoln Park Career Pathways Program, contact Melanie George at 462-7395. 462-7395.
Coming to you live from Stuart, Florida, the greatest little town in the world. It's the Get Up and Go Show on AM 1450 WSTU. You're invited to call the show anytime at 772-220-9788. And now, broadcasting live from their palatial studios, here are your hosts, Evan and Bonnie.
8:07 on the Get Up and Go Show, Bonnie, and it's the day that I have been looking forward to the most. It's the Morning Joe. The Morning Joe with the Stuart Martin Chamber of Commerce, and everybody is there.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning, everybody.
Hi, you all look terrific.
Good morning, guys. Good
morning. Yeah,
everybody, make sure and unmute yourself and turn your microphones on. And just for purposes, please don't take this the wrong way. Do not speak unless you're spoken to. So this way, everybody doesn't talk over everybody, and nobody cuts anybody off. So first and foremost, Joe. I want to say good morning to you, Joe. Thank you so much for allowing us to invade your Morning Joe this morning.
Well, thank you, Evan. Everyone's looking forward to it. We have a great time. We enjoyed the hunt last week, and I know you've got one prepared this week. I don't know if anyone's prepared themselves for it.
Oh, yeah, and especially if you come late to the party today, you will get thrown under the bus right on the radio. So, and there it is. There's somebody that just came late that just popped in, D. Pepper. So, D. Pepper, you need to get a excuse note as to why you're late before you can be admitted and carry on. So you're going to need a note there, whoever D. Pepper is.
There's our friend Jeff Sabin, too. Jeff was the one that brought in the cute little dog a week or two ago. Hi, Jeff.
Definitely. So, well, let's get right to it. Let's give everybody just a few moments to introduce themselves. Caitlin, I'll let you go first. Everybody knows Caitlin. Who doesn't know Caitlin, right?
Good morning, everyone. I'm Caitlin Hartley, the events coordinator for the Stuart Martin County Chamber. This morning, I am Santa, or Santa's helper. And I just wanted to thank Evan and Bonnie for having us on again and you all for joining us.
Oh, it's so much fun. And, of course, next up on the list is Brian with a VIP. That's all I can see on the screen. Hi, Brian.
Good morning, sir. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. Happy Hanukkah. I am Brian with VIP America, home health care referrals. We've been in business since 1997, a small family-owned business right there in Stuart across from the Wawa. Just trying to keep seniors in their house as long as possible and just wishing everybody a Merry Christmas. Let's get through 2020 and into 2021. And if you get a chance to be someone's miracle today, go for it.
Hey, sounds great. Cherie Ramirez, I hope I got that right. Is it Cherie or Sherry?
You got it right the first time, Evan.
Cherie.
Thank you.
Hey,
very
how are
good
you?
Job. It's like the song by Stevie Wonder, My Cherie. Cherie.
Yeah. No.
My Cherie Amore.
My Cherie Amore.
So Cherie with Sky Blue Jet Aviation. I am their marketing manager, and we have Sky Blue Flight Academy. We are rebranding, and that is our primary flight training school where you can come and do a discovery flight with us. We also offer charter services and your own private jet. So we are based out of Witham Field. If anybody is looking to travel or looking to get into the sky and learn how to fly,
wow.
Give me a call.
All right.
Sounds cool.
Great. Diane is standing by with the roofers banging on her roof and the dogs are going crazy. Right, Diana?
They are, so I'm going to make this quick because
right.
I'm in between.
All right.
Diana Moret, the Business Profit Coach. I help business owners in the Treasure Coast and attorneys find profit and keep it in their business.
All right. Thanks so much. Robert Loeb, it's the stage is all yours for a minute.
Thank you, Evan. Happy holidays to everybody. I'm the president of Westchester Benefit Group. Work out of Jensen Beach as well as New York, two offices. And we help businesses help reduce their high cost of employee benefits and health insurance and retirement planning.
Very good. Chuck is up next. Take it away, Chuck.
Hey, guys. Good morning. I'm Chuck Geary with the Lesser Law Firm. We're in downtown Stuart, right across from the courthouse. We have 12 friendly lawyers in four locations. All we do is accident cases. The chamber is our best resource. Love seeing you guys. So one thing we're still doing is the Toys for Tots. They told us to take the sign down and stop collecting because they're organizing over there.
Mm-hmm.
I left the sign up and toys keep flowing in.
All right.
So I think everybody feels guilty right at the end there. And they do that little extra shopping. So the sign is up and we're collecting. I'll keep running over there to the last,
love
last
it.
Second.
Absolutely love it. Absolutely love it. Thank you so
tons
much.
Thank you.
Advertising and marketing. That's all I see for a name. There's no name there. So I guess we're going to call you A&M. So A&M, take it away.
That's good. I'm Aileen Fernudo. And one of the things that I do for my company is I represent people that cannot make it to the chamber. So today I am representing Elite Gas. I am representing the Palm City Hurricane, the Olympic Tavernier, and Tara Beek's businesses. She has Crafted by TBC.
Wow.
And
wonderful.
Also the new real estate book, where I have a really good deal going on right now for January.
Such a bargain. All right, there we go.
Yes.
All right, very good. Maybe she knows Brian Bozzio. They parked the car in the Hobbit Yacht.
I'm sure she does.
Angela is outside enjoying this gorgeous weather. You have to unmute yourself, Angela.
There I am. Sorry. Good morning. My name is Angela Kubik. I'm with DreamWorks Real Estate over in Stuart. I've been in real estate for about 3 years now. We're a newer company, but we're doing really awesome. And you guys should come check us out. We should have a grand opening soon. So come check us out.
All right. Very good. Jackie's standing by with her funky hat. Go ahead, Jackie.
Good morning, all. Happy holidays to everybody. Jackie McNeil with the Better Business Bureau, serving Southeast Florida and the Caribbean since 1969, downtown Stuart. Check out businesses and charities. Don't hesitate to give me a call. Thank you.
All right. Thanks so much. We're going to head over to Kate, where she's on her iPad with a big heart in the middle of her shirt there. Hi, Kate.
Good morning. I am Kate Harper with Habitat for Humanity. We are doing fantastic things. We're super busy this time of year, as you could well imagine, between Restore. We're also finishing up our last six homes in Indiantown.
Mm-hmm.
We have recently partnered up with Harley-Davidson to have a biker build out in Indiantown on January 16th. So we got a lot of fun stuff going on right now.
And excellent. Kate is full of heart.
Yes, definitely. Josh Brown, take it away, Josh.
Good morning, everybody. Josh Brown from CBS 12. If you're a football fan and you'll watch this weekend, you'll see your Florida Gators taking on Alabama in the SEC championship game. If you're lucky, you won't see any shoe shenanigans. Who throws a shoe, honestly? but it'll still be an exciting time.
Oh, really? I can't believe they did that.
Everybody remember to shop local this holiday season. It's easier than you think, and boy, are these guys appreciative when you walk in and spend your hard-earned dollars with the people right here on this call and in this community.
For sure, for sure. Amber Warren is standing by. Amber, good morning. How are you doing?
Good morning. Well, thank you. How are you?
Good.
I'm Amber from the school district, volunteer services liaison, and we can't have too many volunteers right now because of COVID, but if anyone is interested in working with our career and technical education students virtually, we'd be happy to help connect you with that after the new year when everyone's back in school.
All right. Thank you so much. Mike is up next. Mike?
Hi, good morning, everybody. I'm Mike O'Leary from Class 101. We help students and their families find the right college at the right price. And we also help with test preparation. We have a free ACT test for the students on December 29th. And we'll start up with an ACT course on January 5th.
Perfect for anybody wanting to head back to school. Thanks, Mike.
Excellent. Wow. Debbie Greer, take it away, Debbie.
Good morning, everyone. Debbie Greer from the Boys and Girls Club of Martin County. Oops, and I have company this morning who's decided she's going to get in on the action. Hush. We've been collecting toys for backpacks and food boxes to send out to our kids because they're going to be out of school for 2 weeks. So we want to thank all of the supporters. Mark Vallinette with Thrivent, you know, our Thrivent dollars have gone to play there and have done very well. And I want to thank you all.
All right. Very good. Mark, let me see. Vallinette or Vallinette? Which one is it?
Pick one. Vallinette is the proper way to say it, but most people say Vallinette.
Let's do it. Vallinette.
How you doing?
I'm good.
I represent Thrivent Financial in this area, and in a nutshell, what I try to do is I try to help people with financial clarity. The first thing we try to do is just really define a life vision for a human being.
Okay.
And then build a financial plan around that life vision.
Okay.
And that's really the way anybody should go about it. So I help people put their thoughts down.
Okay, very good. Jackie, we're going to have to put you in detention because you did not raise your hand and asked to get up out of your chair to leave the room. So we're going to put you in detention for 5 minutes. Andrea Osorio, if you would please, the stage is all yours.
Hi, good morning, everybody. This is Andrea with the Smile Cakes. We bake delicious cupcakes every single morning, but today I want to introduce our new product, which is the Cocoa Bombs. They are very trendy right now, and we have 4 flavors to offer. We have the traditional hot cocoa, we have Oreo, we have Andes candies, and we also have peppermint. So you can call us, you can come, or you can process orders online at www.smallcakesstuart.com.
All right, very good. Thank you.
Happy holiday for everybody.
All righty. Carmelia, it's all yours.
Good morning, everybody. So I'm the Director of Business Development of Coral Shores Behavioral Health. Recently moved to Florida from Virginia, so I'm becoming a Floridian. And being part of this group is one way to become a Floridian.
Yeah.
Originally from Eastern Europe. That's where that accent comes from. For those who wonder, and I know all of you do. So I'm happy to be here. I'm also a veteran. And yes, I mean, thank you for having me. Caitlin has been amazing, and I know some of you, so thank you for having me.
Jeff Sabin with his Christmas hat on. Hey, Jeff.
Hey, good morning, everybody. Yeah, Merry Christmas to everybody. Jeff Sabin, Government Affairs Manager for Waste Management of Martin County. Also used food dealer, and I'm also chairman of the Board of Directors of the Stuart Martin Chamber of Commerce. I'm proudly doing that, so. Remember to take care of your drivers. It's that time of year. Yeah. So thank you so much.
Definitely so. And last but certainly not least, I'm starting to wonder if he's frozen because he hasn't moved one iota of an inch, is Mark Vallinette. All I see is a photo there.
Well, you already got me.
Oh, there he is. Okay.
He's back.
Yeah, I don't want to put my face on too long.
Oh, there he is. Okay.
No, you're
fine. You moved around there. Okay.
You handsome man.
So anyway, so we got everybody in. Looks like somebody had to drop off, but that's okay. So what we're going to do, we're going to play a little game with you guys. And in my hand right here, as you can see, is a gift certificate to Ellie's Downtown Deli. That's what's up for grabs this morning. So we're going to go on a little Christmas scavenger hunt. Bonnie's going to keep track of who has the most items. We're going to rattle off in a 10-minute time span. We're going to rattle off different things. And whoever can bring it back first and show it on the screen will get a point.
Yeah, whoever can like bring back the most items for us.
All right, so Bonnie, you want to start off with one of our first items? Make it kind of... not too easy, but not too hard.
Well, you know, something that, you know, everybody might have this time of year is simply a tree ornament.
Oh, a tree ornament. Okay. Go bring us back a tree ornament. First one back with a tree ornament.
Just went to his whole tree.
Well, no, that doesn't count.
Oh, we have Angela.
Angela
Kubik.
Yeah, you can't show us the whole tree.
Come on.
All right. So Angela has a point.
Yep.
Okay, Angela has a point. Bonnie, go ahead and give us another one, if you would.
Would anybody have a elf on a shelf?
Oh, the elf on the shelf. Let's see. Who's got the elf on the shelf? No, that doesn't qualify, Brian. Need to see the elf on the shelf.
We're seeing some Santa Claus ears right there.
Nobody has.
Oh, we have the advertising.
Is that the elf on the shelf? Let's see it.
Andrea.
No, that's not the elf on the shelf. That is not the official elf on the shelf. There's Josh.
Josh Brown has it.
Josh has the elf on the shelf. All right. Very good. Now, Josh, does your elf have a name?
Buddy.
Buddy the elf. Okay. So, Josh, now you have to keep your elf tucked in your collar there while you're on this Zoom call for the rest of the call, okay? And then make sure somebody comes in with a live camera and we get this on the news. There we go. All right. Very good. So the next item we're going to look for is I want to say you have to find a piece of mistletoe and you have to kiss a pet under the mistletoe. You have to kiss your pet under the mistletoe. Let's see. Oh, there's the mistletoe, but you don't have a pet there.
Hold on.
Wait a minute. Wait. Hold it. Yes. Look at Brian.
Yes.
Look at Brian.
Oh my god.
Oh, that is so cute.
Yay. Oh yeah.
Wow, Brian.
Caitlin, that was very creative. That was very creative.
I like that.
Ew, it's not even a dog, it's my friend's dog, but you know, I gotta do what you gotta do.
Do what you gotta do, right?
Wow.
The dog doesn't mind who's kissing them, right?
Okay. Here's an item that you can show us. Show us something Christmas related that you would wear from the waist down. Christmas related that you would wear from the waist down. Okay, let's see what we have.
Brian took off.
Brian took off. I can only imagine what Brian's going to come back with. This is going to be very
easy one, but since no one's wearing long pants these days.
Santa Claus shorts.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, that
all
looks right. Christmas all enough. Right. So Brian gets another
Brian,
point.
He's got 2 points.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, Bonnie, what do you have for me?
How about an ugly Christmas sweater or just an ugly sweater in general?
Yeah, just an ugly Christmas sweater.
Sherry took off.
Yeah, Diane took off. Sherry took off.
Hey, Roxy.
There goes Josh. Oh, and it looks like Diane.
Diana.
Oh, boy.
I think Diana just got in time.
Just like a nudge quicker.
Yeah.
But it was very close with Cherie and Diana.
Okay, all right.
So Diana the point with that one.
All right, very good. Very, very good. Bonnie, what else you got for me?
How about, so we mentioned going to the refrigerator.
Yes. Oh, this is going to be a good one.
Not for any beer.
No, no beers right now because we're on radio.
How about bring us back some eggnog?
Yeah, show us some eggnog.
Eggnog.
No.
Nobody's moving on the eggnog.
Advertising. Mark disappeared. Ann is going.
Yeah, Mark disappeared. And
Lean's got eggnog.
Brian. Wow, Brian.
Here comes.
Brian. Oh, Brian's got the eggnog.
Oh my goodness.
Eggs. Wow. Oh, wait a minute. Brian, come back here. Let me see that, Brian.
It's a carton of eggs.
No, that's not eggnog.
That's close.
There, it looks like Mark has the eggnog. Very good.
Well,
there
it is. Eggnog, too.
There we go.
Low-fat eggnog.
Low-fat eggnog. Okay, that's very good.
Any brandy
Jackie,
in it?
Jackie, you're just a day late and a dollar too short.
I'm going to put some in my coffee while it's out.
Wait a minute. What does Jackie have there? That looks like an adult beverage.
A large one.
A large adult beverage. Okay. All right. Poor Kate. She's been sitting there with her arms crossed.
Caitlin, we want... Oh, wish right. we could get you right. one to get you moving, girl.
Kate, show me a Christmas ornament attached to a heart on a shirt.
Okay.
There we go. There we go. Yay. Okay, very good. All right. So now, show me a menorah. There you go. Show me a menorah.
Jackie's had a hard time with her menorah. She lit something on fire the other night.
Did she really?
Yeah. My menorah is very sad. So
oh, no.
No, I'm not going to show you. I'm not showing you.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Bonnie, what do you got for me?
Okay, should we make this the last one, Evan?
We'll do two or three more.
Okay,
yeah.
So this has to do with the Christmas tree again. Bring us back a Christmas star.
Oh, a Christmas star.
Or any star. Just show us a star.
He's taking the star off the tree. And he's bringing it over.
We got full view of that.
There it is.
Brian, congratulations.
It's still lit, too.
Wow. Okay.
Still lit.
It's still lit. Okay. All right. Very good. Very good. Show us a Christmas card. Show us a Christmas card. There's Amber. Amber got a Christmas card. Advertising and Brian. Okay. Bonnie, you want to tally up the score? Diana had one also. So, Bonnie, who has the most?
Okay, so who had the Christmas card brought out first?
Oh,
I need to know.
I don't know. I wasn't paying attention.
Oh,
I think it was Amber.
Amber?
Was it Amber? Okay. Amber was quick on that
so
one.
So we have...
Oh, I just thought of another one.
Yeah?
Show me some Christmas glasses. Christmas glasses.
Glasses.
Brian must have everything.
Those aren't
Brian
Christmas
loaded up
Mark.
For this game.
He did. Got to put them on.
Oh, he went cup glasses.
He went cup glasses.
Oh, that's not specified.
Okay. All right. Very good.
So that was Brian again. We have a Brian in the lead of everybody with a large margin by 4.
So it looks like Brian's our winner.
I think so.
Congratulations to Brian. Brian gets an Ellie's Downtown Deli gift certificate.
Brian, it's almost like we peered into your home today and chose everything for you just to grab easily. But you had it right there, and enjoy some lunch from Ellie's Deli in Stuart.
Yes, I'll drop the gift certificate off to, in fact, where's it at right here? I'm going to write Brian's name on it as we speak. Bonnie, can I borrow your pen, please, for a minute?
Absolutely.
Thank you, dear.
Should I go over there and say hi to everybody in front of your computer, Evan, so they can see
me? Yeah, come on over so they can see
you. Okay.
So they can see who this wonderful Bonnie is.
We got Elf on the Shelf,
too. Oh, no, you touched the Elf.
Swagger.
Bonnie, you touched Swagga.
I wasn't supposed to touch
him. No, Bonnie.
Oh, my goodness.
Bonnie, you touched Swagga.
I didn't know that.
Bonnie touched Swagga. He's going to lose his magical powers.
Oh, okay.
Here, let me have Swagga.
5 minutes in lockdown.
See, here's Swagga.
Ah.
Here's Bonnie, so everybody can see. There's Bonnie right there.
I didn't know I wasn't.
There
hey,
she
Bonnie.
Is.
Bonnie.
Now it's
going to
bring me bad luck for the rest
there
of the day.
There she is. Oh, no. What am I going to do? I'm going to be really upset here. My poor elf.
Oh, my gosh.
Let me hang Swagga back up.
Okay. I won't be touching him anymore.
He's got a mask. All right. So, anyway... I'm going to stop down to the chamber a little bit later on today. Joe, I'll drop that off to you in the morning in a little bit for Brian. Okay. And Caitlin, when is the next morning, Joe, so I can put it on my calendar?
January 21st.
January 21st. Okay, so everybody mark the date down in your calendar, January the 21st. And that's the date when we're all going to reconvene for a 2021 Morning Joe.
Mm-hmm.
All right. It'll be Thursday the 21st, 8 o'clock in the morning. It's on my calendar. Hey, guys, thank you so much for letting us invade. I'm going to let you guys go on with your Morning Joe and have a great time. And thank you guys so much. Everybody, have a Merry Christmas.
Have a Merry Christmas,
happy
everybody.
Happy Hanukkah and a very, very happy Christmas. New Year.
Thanks, Evan. Bye.
Thank you.
Bye. Thank you.
Thanks, WSTU.
Thank you.
It's our pleasure. Bye-bye. God bless everybody. All right, we're going to take a short commercial break, and when we come back, we're going to speak to Randy Segal with a space report. So don't go anywhere.
The first.
first time I stepped into St. Lucie Jewelry and Coins, I figured it would just be one of my many stops on my road to the perfect engagement ring. My fiancé means the world to me, so I wanted something extra special. I found a huge selection of engagement rings at great prices, and my worry about finding the perfect engagement ring was quickly replaced with exceptional customer service. St. Lucie Jewelry's over 400 five-star reviews really told the story. I finally picked a ring, and it was perfect. She was floored, and then the tears came.
Hi, this is Hawk Levy, owner of St. Lucie Jewelry and Coins. We're now celebrating 26 years, voted best diamond dealers, best jewelry buyers, and best jeweler year after year. Come celebrate with us in opening our third location at 1335 St. Lucie West Boulevard next to Publix. We invite you to take a tour of our competition, but then come see us last.
This will be another El Nino year, although a weaker one. So if you incurred roof damage in the last 2 years, Code Red Roofers is there to help you with all of your roofing needs. Code Red Roofers, the roofers who respond 24-7. And there are flexible payment options for metal, tile, shingle, or flat roofs. Code Red Roofers, se habla español. Code Red Roofers, 844-4-CODE-RED. That's 844-4-CODE-RED.
The professionals at Mark Breckville Certified Public Accountants are proud to sponsor Treasure Coast Solutions, a community service program designed to provide information you can use, a local perspective on national issues, local solutions to meet your individual concerns. At our firm, we believe that information is knowledge, and with knowledge comes the power to have a positive impact on our lives, businesses, schools, and community. If you would like one of our professionals to address your personal financial or business concerns, please give us a call to set up an appointment at 220-3380.
Are you an entrepreneur or business owner along the Treasure Coast? Well, then you should be tuning in to Small Biz Florida from the Florida Small Business Development Center at Indian River State College. Hi, I'm Tom Kindred, your host for Small Biz Florida. Entrepreneurs and business owners will learn how the Florida SBDC and IRSC can help you start, grow, and accelerate your business.
Monday mornings at 11 on WSTU 1450 and worldwide on WPSLTV.com.
Are you looking for your dream home on the Treasure Coast? I am Eileen Simons, a licensed realtor with eXp Realty. My team and I can help you find your dream home. I bring 20-plus years experience in the residential real estate market, helping both buyers and sellers achieve their dreams. Call me at 772-200-5105 or visit our website at mydreamhomeusa.com.
Here's a quick tip. If you're ever stumped for a business you can trust, the Martin County Business Exchange has more than 70 companies you can count on for good service and fair prices. Whether it's for you, your house, or your office, get online at mcbiz.us. You'll find local businesses you can count on for quality, service, and fair prices. Visit mcbiz.us. Martin County Business Exchange. It's just good business.
If you have a suggestion for the show, we would love to hear from you. Send us an email to WSTUmorningshow@gmail.com. Now let's get back to the Get Up and Go show. Here's Evan and Bonnie.
8:33 right now, time for the Space Report. Let's quickly go to Randy Segal. Good morning, Randy, and how are you today, sir?
I am great, sir. And yourself?
I'm very well, thank you.
Good, and Bonnie as well.
Yes, thank you, Randy. I'm glad you're doing well also.
Thanks, appreciate that. But did you guys know that it was back in 1903, on this date in history, that the Wright brothers flew the first plane from Kitty Hawk, North Carolina? Yep, it was the first time an airplane has flown with a passenger on board. In 2011, NASA launched its Grail Recovery and Internal Laboratory towards the moon. It was two spacecrafts that would help us better understand the lunar surface. And then they launched in 2017 a Soyuz MS spacecraft to the International Space Station. The crew consisted of an American, a Russian, and a Japanese doctor. The astronauts on board the International Space Station continue their research into the human body. The cardiac heart study that's been underway now all week, where the crew observes engineered heart tissue samples through a microscope in the Kibo laboratory module. The samples are being processed inside the life science glove box to help researchers understand and treat abnormal heart cells and tissues that could lead to disease both on Earth and in space. Gravity allows them, anti-gravity there allows them to do a lot of this research. So this is ongoing on the space station. Get ready for launch day. That's right. Today, at 9:45, SpaceX is expected to launch their Falcon 9 rocket. They delayed it 45 minutes from its original 9 o'clock time due to weather. They want to allow the weather to pass it by. So now, everything is on track for 9:45, weather permitting. So we'll have to monitor that. And probably one of the best patches I have ever seen for a launch, the Falcon 9 is going to place into orbit a National Reconnaissance Laboratory satellite. And their patch shows a gorilla beating its chest, saying, "Peace through strength." And that really describes that particular mission. Over in India, they had another successful launch, which placed a new communications satellite into orbit. India has been quite prolific this year on the launchings that they have had. A memorandum of understanding has been signed between the European Space Agency and NASA. The memorandum of understanding will take the Europeans to the moon. They will now be part of the Artemis project and the Artemis Accords. So it's going to be very interesting to see that this particular memorandum makes everything work. However, the Office of the Inspector General, the General Accountability's Office, says that NASA's human space exploration is not going the way it should be. They're saying, in short, that unless NASA reins in exactly what they're doing, there's no way they can reach the moon by 2024. The cost has increased by 42.5% compared to the 2014 projections that they originally had for this launch vehicle. And whether or not they'll be able to launch on that date is questionable. You may recall that with the Artemis project, they're going to have three missions that'll be heading towards the moon. Artemis 1, which will be launched next year, will be an uncrewed test flight. Artemis 2 will have a crew going around the moon, and then on Artemis in 2003, and in 2024, Artemis 3 will land on the moon. We also had a new act that was passed by Congress. Congress has passed a bipartisan bill that said that when we go back to the moon, we should preserve all of the Apollo landing heritage. In other words, the locations where the astronauts from America landed on the moon should not be desecrated, if you will. They want to be certain that it leaves that legacy on the moon from the United States. Also, we know that there is now a new national space policy that has been initiated by the Trump administration. Mike Pence, vice president, has committed to handling the National Space Council, and they have come up with a lot of different details and things they want to do. So the question now begs itself, what's going to happen when we have a new administration? are we going to be in trouble or are we not going to be in trouble? Tomorrow we'll tell you about a new Cygnus freighter going to the space station and the work of Blue Origins. So until tomorrow, have a great day, everybody.
That's Randy Segal with the Space Report. He'll be back tomorrow morning with us at 8:30. He's here Monday through Friday at 8:30, joining us on the broadcast. Time to head on over to Ellie's Downtown Deli, where Bonnie is standing by.
Well, thank you, Evan. And Ellie's Deli, where they serve the fresh jumbo wraps. Fresh jumbo wraps include the flour tortillas with tomato, basil, spinach, or garlic herb with some goodness, you know, wrapped in. Enjoy a turkey wrap this afternoon with some oven gold turkey, shredded cheddar, lettuce, tomatoes, some alfalfa sprouts in there, and honey mustard. Or maybe you want the vegetarian wrap with lettuce and cucumbers, alfalfa sprouts included, tomatoes, carrots, onions, garlic mayo, cheddar, and mozzarella. This vegetarian wrap is wonderful. Enjoy with a hot bowl of soup today. Take home some Oreo pie for dessert. At Ellie's Downtown Deli and Stuart, now with their patio back open, plus they're at 50% dining inside with a full menu for pickup or delivery. Ellie's also has full dinners available for takeout, plus their fabulous desserts as well. Call 772-781-6605 to order and pick up today. They're at 18 Southeast 6th Street, just off Colorado and Stuart. Call 772-781-6605. Ellie's Downtown Deli and Stuart.
Time for the Precious Metals Report. It's all brought to you by St. Lucie Jewelry and Coin. Gold opening up at $1,884.60 an ounce, and silver opening up $25.85 an ounce. That's the Precious Metals Report. It's all brought to you by St. Lucie Jewelry and Coin. News time one final time this morning for this Thursday. Let's go to the news desk, and here's Bonnie.
Thanks once again, Evan. Some school districts in our area are now reaching out to Tallahassee and asking Florida Governor Ron DeSantis to make teachers a priority for the COVID-19 vaccine. WPTV's Ryan Hughes has details.
For 18 years, Chris Waldrop has been teaching students, but he says balancing in-person instruction and virtual learning has been his biggest challenge during the pandemic at St. Louis West Centennial High School.
There'll be times where, like, my physical class will have 26 students in it, and then all of a sudden there's a quarantine list sent out and like 10 of those kids are gone.
St. Lucie School Superintendent Wayne Jent says he expects more students to return to the classroom after winter break and is now having conversations about the COVID-19 vaccine and getting educators vaccinated.
So that is a priority for us to make sure that when the next batch comes out, that those that have direct contact with students are included.
Jen says he will take the vaccine, but it would be voluntary for teachers and staff.
This will be just one less thing that needs to be worried about by our instructors, our teachers, our bus drivers.
Here in Martin County, the school board voted Tuesday night to send a formal request to Governor Ron DeSantis asking district employees with direct contact with students to be considered a priority to receive the vaccine.
The governor has said he expects the Johnson & Johnson vaccine to receive approval after the new year. And on Tuesday in West Palm Beach, the governor said it's expected to only require one dose.
That makes it easier to do on a mass scale because you can go and in a school district can offer it to the teachers one shot and you don't have to worry about going back.
Waldrop does not want to be pushed to the front of the line, but says he does want the vaccine.
I hope people would understand the importance of getting the vaccine so that we can all be healthy and, you know, live somewhat of a normal life again.
Ryan Hughes, WPTV. News Channel 5.
And the coronavirus vaccine is already being administered to Florida's frontline healthcare workers.
I got mine at the beginning of my shift, and I felt fine. A little bit sore in my arm now, but other than that, I felt good. I got through my shift.
Yes. In Orlando, Advent Health Nurse Manager Sue Upper says a line of doctors stretched into the lobby as they queued up to get the vaccine. Advent Health received its first shipment of 20,000 vaccine doses earlier this week. Indian River State College has received the largest donation in its history, $45 million, putting it among nearly 400 organizations getting donations from philanthropist Mackenzie Scott. The donation was announced Wednesday. In the past 4 months, Scott has given nearly $4.2 billion to 384 organizations across all 50 states. The donation to IRSC will support initiatives at the college, such as growing career training and degree programs, according to the college. Lastly, SpaceX is set to launch a spy satellite into orbit for the U.S. National Reconnaissance Office this morning. The flight is scheduled to blast off from Pad 39A at Kennedy Space Center during a planned three-hour window that opens at 9 a.m. However, the exact liftoff time has not yet been announced. The first day of college football's early signing period is over, and despite all the restrictions and abnormalities from COVID-19, a significant number of big-name prospects signed their national letters of intent. They include five stars Corey Foreman and Terrence Lewis, and ESPN 300 prospects Tristan Lay, Sire Wright, and Elijah Judy, who are all planning to announce on January 2nd. News time, it's 8:45. We'll have weather and traffic together next.
As we work to reopen the economy, a renaissance has begun in the world of investing. And if you're retired or within 10 years of retirement and your current advisor isn't prepared for the new corona economy, it could lead to costly mistakes you cannot afford to make at this point in your life. We're the Retirement Income Store, and our message is clear. It's time to stop crossing your fingers, hoping for growth in the stock market. There is another more conservative way to plan for income without all the risk, using interest and dividends. Call the Retirement Income Store today at 800-211-5872 for your free, no-obligation retirement income kit, including five educational tools.
That's 800-211-5872.
The Retirement Income Store, where retirees go for income.
That's 800-211-5872.
.846 right now, the Get Up and Go Show with Evan and Bonnie. It's time for traffic and weather together, all brought to you by Code Red Roofers. Bonnie?
We do see one accident. It's on I-95 northbound up in Fort Pierce at mile marker 126, and this is northbound a little bit past Glades Cutoff Road, and no roadblock up ahead in that area from the accident. That's your latest look at traffic. Right now it's 72 degrees. Here in Stuart, in Loveland, Colorado this morning, it's 16 above. Here's our forecast at WPTV.
It is going to be a relatively warm morning along the Treasure Coast. We've got some clouds overhead. Also, chance for some patchy fog, too. We will see a stray sprinkle possible early, but a better chance of some isolated downpours into the late morning and early afternoon hours. Temperatures still going to climb into the low and middle 70s for your afternoon high temperatures. As we look toward tonight, that cold front moves on through. Jacket weather does return.
I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Harrison Hove on WSTU AM 1450, Martin County's Heritage Station.
Time to find that dream home. I am Eileen Simons, realtor with EXP Realty. Join me for My Dream Home every Monday morning at 10 on WPSL and WSTU. We'll talk about real estate, interview guest experts, have featured listings, and a featured community each week. That's My Dream Home radio show, Mondays at 10 on WPSL and WSTU, Alexa and Google Home on TuneIn.
The Florida Department of Health in Martin County urges everyone to protect themselves and their loved ones this holiday season. Keep your holidays happy by taking some simple steps to prevent the spread of the coronavirus. Wash your hands often with soap. Cover your coughs and sneezes. Stay home when you're sick. Clean high-touch surface frequently and use a face mask and social distance and avoid crowds. Learn more at martincountyhealth.com.
If you have a suggestion for the show, we would love to hear from you. Send us an email to wstumorningshow@gmail.com. Now let's get back to the Get Up and Go show. Here's Evan and Bonnie.
Come on in to Al's Tree Barn. We've got the perfect tree to bring in the holidays and turn your cat into a tree-destroying, violent lunatic. These trees are full, green, and built to be tipped over by a cat that has turned itself into a 30-mile-per-hour projectile. Crashing into that $800 TV you bought Black Friday shopping. Need a fake tree instead? Ours are pre-lit, so your cat can tear it from limb to limb, creating an electrical fire that can only be described as soul-crushing. But hey, cats, you gotta love them. Merry Christmas from Al's Tree Barn.
We can fly where you want to. We can leave your house behind. But if your friends don't mask, and why don't they mask? Well, they won't fly this airline.
You can fly if you want to, cause we do safety right. We have air that's clean and disinfectant machines, zapping germs like an arcade space fight. And we dance,
do the dance, do the dance.
Everybody wash some hands.
Do the dance, do the dance, while always wearing a mask. Do the dance, do the dance.
No, seriously, please wash your hands.
Do the dance, do the dance.
HEPA filters cleaning commence.
Alaska Safety Dance.
That's a parody of the song Safety Dance by the Men Without Hats.
Yeah, they almost
for Alaska
do it as,
Airlines.
They almost do it as good as them, don't they?
I know,
they?
Right?
As well as them.
That was pretty gosh darn good, wasn't it?
That wasn't bad. And I like the idea of a huge sanitizer for the airplanes.
Definitely. Let's see who's on the ho-ho-ho hotline this morning. Hi, you're on the ho-ho-ho hotline. Who's this?
Good morning, guys, from North Pole, Alaska.
Oh, wow. You're up at the North Pole?
Yes. It's 11 below zero here.
Wow.
And wind chill is 28 degrees below zero.
Are you out there ice fishing, old man?
Well, right now, we only have 3 hours and 47 minutes of daylight.
Oh, yeah, because you're in the land of the midnight sun, right?
Oh, yeah. It's only 452 here.
Oh, my goodness gracious.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm about 4,000-something miles from you guys.
Oh, my gosh. You're far, far away.
Yeah, it's cold up here, you know, and the start of the big fire, because, you know, we got to stay warm up here. But it's beautiful up here. She almost got run over by a reindeer. Old grandma.
Oh. Don't you get a little depressed when it's so dark out all the time at the North Pole?
Hey, old man, hold on 1 second, old man. My other line's ringing, so hold on 1 second.
Okay.
Hi, good morning. You're on Santa's hotline. Who's this?
Meow.
Oh, it's Big Kitty. Okay, meow. So we have Big Kitty and the old man meow on the phone.
Oh, my goodness. Hey, Big Kitty.
Meow.
Wow.
You want to come up to the North Pole?
Meow.
Yeah, oh, Big Kitty wants to go to the North Pole. Okay.
Yeah. Well,
very interesting.
I'm surprised Big Kitty doesn't want to stay down here in warm Florida.
Yeah, in the
with
warm
us.
Florida. Hey, Big Kitty, is Fredo around or Fredo's out gallivanting?
Well.
Okay.
Got a new business for Fredo up here in the North Pole.
Oh, yeah? What would the new business be, old man?
Shoveling snow.
Oh, yeah. Big Kitty thought that was funny. Okay.
Take a picture of it when he comes up there to do that.
Yeah, please do. I definitely would like to see that,
we
without a doubt.
We can witness Fredo actually doing some work.
So, Big Kitty, quick question for you. What do you want for Christmas? Could you tell us what's on your Christmas list?
Well,
you can? Well, okay. All right. Well, all right.
Well,
and what else?
Well,
okay.
Well,
okay. Sounds interesting. Well, oh, okay. We can do that. Oh, I don't know if we could do that one. Okay.
It sounds like Kratos petting Big Kitty.
Yeah.
With a little purr going on.
Purr going on there.
Big Kitty, are you knocking everything off of Fredo's shelf?
Yes.
No.
Yeah, Big Kitty's being mischievous.
Are you climbing up Fredo's Christmas tree?
Oh, you are. Okay. All right. Are you playing with the ornaments? Yes. Okay. All right.
Playing with the elf in the shelf.
Yeah. Stay away from the elf on the shelf. Bonnie's already touched the elf on the shelf here, and it's lost its magical power.
Yeah, I touched Swagga.
Bonnie, what'd you do that for?
Yeah, she touched Swagga.
I grabbed Swagga.
I'm going to have to get in there to talk to you.
I
wanted to show Swagga right to everybody that was in our Zoom meeting this morning and show them my face because they couldn't see me on camera. They could only see Evan. And then I tried to grab Swagga to come along with me, and I guess I wasn't supposed to do that.
Yeah. That's all right. I'll have to get Swagga back its magical powers somehow. I don't know how I'm going to do that. So anyway.
If North Pole has some magical powers, we can just probably swing it down by that way.
Oh, we could do that. Yeah, that might work. Okay, I'm trying to fix Swagga here. Swagga's all messed up.
Santa's still up here, so he's got all the elves working.
Oh, that's right. I forgot about that. Yeah.
Yeah, he's getting ready for his big night already next week. I'm so excited. Don't you just still get excited for Santa to arrive?
I do. There's the cat's purring again.
No.
What do you want, Big Kitty?
I think he loves Santa.
Speak to me, Big Kitty. Tell me what you want. Okay. All right. Very good. All right. We'll get that taken care of for you. We're going to continue our conversation with the old man, Big Kitty, and we'll let you run, and we will talk at you. Check in with us tomorrow, please, because tomorrow's my last day before vacation. All right? All right. You have a good day,
And don't
Big
break
Kitty.
Any bulbs on Fredo's tree.
Yes, please don't do that.
Yeah.
So, old man, what's going on up at the North Pole? What's the activity going on up there?
Well, right now we got a lot of the Eskimos making Eskimo pies,
Okay.
And Edna's been chasing moose around.
Moose?
Yeah.
What about Bullwinkle?
Rocky's on it.
Oh, okay.
Oh!
All right. Okay.
Edna's making some Christmas cookies for Santa, helping out Mrs. Claus.
Okay. Rachel made a bunch of Christmas cookies at the house last night.
Oh, I heard that.
Oh, yeah. Goodness. They were, I kind of grabbed one off of the cooling rack and ate one real quick.
Ooh,
I know. Dr. Tredd is not going to be happy about that.
I'm going to tell Santa about that.
No, please don't do that, okay? I want to keep on Santa's nice list.
My favorite always is the cookies with the white chocolate, like it's called almond bark. And then I like candy canes. I like to crush candy canes and mix it up with that.
Okay.
With the almond bark, it tastes really good.
All right, that sounds good.
Mm-hmm. I think Ghirardelli sells them, too, at the store.
Well, old man, we're going to let you go because we're coming up to the end of the show. So you have a wonderful day. And check in with us tomorrow. Where are you going to be tomorrow? Are you still going to be hanging at the North Pole?
Yeah, we're going to stay all the way here until Santa leaves.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we're going to help out a little here,
Okay.
We're going to make some
children's dreams come true.
Oh, that's such a good thing you're doing.
And you get to see that magical moment when Santa takes off with a sleigh of reindeer.
Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah, it's a magical, and you get to see the stars and the. And the lights up here,
It sounds so gorgeous.
Wow. It's so mystical.
All right. Well, old man, listen, you have a great day, and we'll talk to you soon.
Okay. You guys have a real good day now.
All right. We will, old man. Thank you so much for calling. Well, Bonnie.
He's always so sweet, isn't he?
It is. Him and Edna. They've been following me forever, and they follow me from station to station. And
sounds like they follow Santa Claus around, too.
They do. And they're going to actually be helping Santa this year.
Yeah, in their Winnebago. Maybe bringing all the presents from their Winnebago, right?
We'll see. Anything's possible.
One filled with them and filled with dreams.
Hey, folks, listen. This holiday season, as you're out and about and, you see people around, if you have it in your heart, do a good deed for somebody. If you want to pay for somebody's lunch or pay for somebody's food that's in line, behind you at a drive-thru while you're getting yours, or if you're at the grocery store and you want to just kind of slide your credit card in the machine right as the other person in front of you is getting ready to slide theirs and just say, Merry Christmas.
Wow. Wow. Or you know, maybe just smile at someone. Sometimes it's even hard to get a smile out of people nowadays.
Definitely so.
That smiling definitely will go a long way.
Without a doubt. Folks, we leave you with the fact that we have a lot of love in this room. And we want to send it out to everybody that's listening to us within earshot. We're WSTU Stuart. We're Martin County's Heritage Station. We'll see you right back here tomorrow morning. Bye-bye for now.